Hi guys, it's K-Bar Ginger here. So, Cassandra and I did this video a couple of weeks ago, and I've been messing around with my video a lot and the video editing software I have, trying to get it to match up with the audio, and I'm having a couple other problems with it, and it's just not working out. So what I did is I made a little animation to go over for the visual part of it, and then I just stuck our audio on it. As you can tell from the video, our audio was also not working properly, but it was our first video and I really wanted to post it. I didn't want it to go to waste. So I went ahead and made this animation for it, and I know it's shitty quality. And if I came across this, I probably wouldn't listen to it because Cassandra's voice, her mic wasn't working. When I first put together the equipment and did tests on it right before we did the video, the equipment worked fine. So yeah, I don't know what happened with that, but without further ado, here is our very first Let's Talk Geek episode with my friend Cassandra and I talking about games. Enjoy.
Yeah, so I have to pull out and up and then like around circle the parking lot. Make sure there's no witnesses. All right, so today we're talking about gaming.
Woo!
Woo, gaming!
Boys,
I got some
girls talk about gaming.
We need to be in the kitchen making sandwiches.
Making babies.
Making babies and sandwiches at the same time.
Yeah.
That'd
be a good sandwich.
Although.
What kind of games?
Tasty sandwiches.
Upcoming games, right?
Yeah, so I wanted to talk about... I'm just going to leave this over here. I don't know why I'm swaddling it like a child. I don't know. Just like our favorites of things.
Yeah.
And then pull up some trailers of some pretty cool stuff that I've seen.
Yeah. That will eventually come out because I'm gaming life.
Yeah, hopefully. I know here recently, the past couple of years, they've been like... Oh, here's a trailer, and then you're going to see it in a decade. Yeah. Or they'll cancel it completely.
Yeah.
Like PT, I'm still upset about that. So upset. Yeah. Silent Hill's bae for me. I love Silent Hill. No, go away. Okay, cool. We're still recording. Pop-up happened. I clicked cancel. Everything's okay. All right. Okay. So, I know your favorite console already, but let's talk a little bit about it.
Okay.
So, favorite console. Favorite, series? That's not right.
Series?
Of, like, consoles. What?
Oh,
like, the brand, and then, like, your specific favorite console out of that.
Oh, like, out of those... sequels, basically.
Yeah, I don't know what to call them, okay? We're not technically inclined.
So I am a Sony person. I've always liked... I've always liked PlayStation the best. Just because, like, I played all the Nintendo games. One of my first games was Super Mario 64, and it was fun, but I didn't get addicted to it, like, certain games on the PlayStation. So I started gaming at about 8 years old, like, officially, I guess. My stepdad had a Dreamcast. Ooh, that's a dinosaur. And I played Crazy Taxi on it, and I loved it.
Crazy Taxi.
Yeah, do you remember that game?
No.
Like, you're literally a fucking crazy Uber driver that picked up people and like you just go through town wrecking shit. And,
it
like,
was beyond its time.
And like it would give you like 40 seconds, and but it would be on the other side of town, and you have to like.
The original GTA.
Yeah, but it was like it wasn't like actually killing people with blood. But it was still like fun. The Simpsons had a similar game that they actually went through a lawsuit because Crazy Taxi was like, you stole our brand.
Oh.
So, anyway, but that was one of my first games. But my very first console was given to me by my stepdad and my mom, and it was the PlayStation 1.
Mm.
I love that system. I played. I don't care if you play like Dark Souls, the very beginning Harry Potter games are so hard.
Yeah, they were.
They were ridiculous.
They were. I remember them. I had them on. Well, my sisters and I, yeah, because there were so many of us, we didn't get individual shit.
Yeah.
But we had them on the Game Boy. No, it wasn't the Advance. It was one that flips out like this. It
was Game Boy SP?
I think. Because yeah. The Game Boy Advance was like a block.
Right. It was like it was a made-up shape.
Yeah. It was a mystery shape like this. But no, it was the one that opened.
Now,
and
there
we had
a Game Boy Advance that did flip open. I think it was called Game Boy Advance SP.
I think it was some sort of
like that. But, yeah,
letters after
about.
It. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where the game's, like, tiny, almost like this, and, like,
excuse me, I just burped on the...
Nice.
This coffee's delicious.
I was really afraid that I was going to be the first one to do that, because I felt like I have carbon.
It happens, whatever. I don't care. Literally, the only people who are going to watch this is, like, our friends.
Oh, that's okay.
So, whatever. Hi, friends! Hi! Oh, we're famous!
But I loved it, of course, because yeah. That's what I was into. I still into.
At the time, they were like, obviously. I thought they were so cool because, like, Harry Potter was bae, and then they came out with games for it, and I was like, you can play as a wizard! This is amazing!
Yeah, well, the thing I liked about the games, even though they were incredibly, like, hard, they showed the things like the peeves and stuff.
Yeah.
That you didn't get in the movies. We didn't get the cool ghosts and stuff.
Yeah.
And I thought that was really cool, and you could go into, like, different rooms. Remember, you could find, like, different chambers and stuff.
Yeah,
and
yeah. I remember, I think it was, I can't remember which game it was, but one of them, you start out in Gringotts, and you have to go down and get your gold and shit. One of the...
That's a Sorcerer's Stone.
Is it? Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, I played, that one was so hard, and Travis Brown, have you ever watched this? But he was the first one to ever
play. Shout out to Travis Brown.
He's the first one. He was the first one I knew to actually beat that game. On
really?
PlayStation 1. He beat that game.
I don't think I beat anything that I played when I was a kid.
Oh, right. Well, the only one I'm going to get to about the PlayStation, but, like, I never beat any of those Harry Potter games. I played.
Yeah.
The only one I beat was on the Game Boy Advance, and it was the Sorcerer's Stone one, and it was hard AF.
Yeah.
It was like, you know. Spoiler alert, if you don't know the ending to the fucking Forest of Sorcerer's Stone, but, like, Professor Quirrell is, of course, like, Voldemort's on the back of his head. And the object of the game was you had to cast a spell into that mirror, and it would ricochet and hit him, because for some reason a direct hit toward him with your thing didn't work.
Yeah.
But if it ricocheted off the mirror and hit him,
yeah.
It worked.
Yeah, it's weird, like, game for work. a lot of games that were in... I don't know, the following years after they started getting, like, the parts that were loaded that you could see were bigger,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, they started expanding their technology.
Yeah.
They expanded, like, I felt like they were making huge progress in certain areas of the game, but not in other areas. So they had, like, the right idea, and they had mm-hmm. the right... aesthetics. They had the capabilities to make the aesthetics, but they didn't have the capabilities to make, like, the mechanics. So, like, the mechanics were beyond their time, you know?
Absolutely.
Like, they were, like, way hard.
And I think it made the quality.
Yeah.
Actually, one time when I was drunk, I went and watched, like, gameplay of the PlayStation 1 Harry Potter game.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I actually just sat there and did watch it. I was like, oh, I wish I could play this again.
It's crazy because, like, when you first play it, I don't know. I don't know if it's because we were kids when we played all this stuff. And...
Yeah.
Sorry.
People like, we're still kids. Actually, we're in our mid-20s.
Yeah, so fuck off. I have adult real-life problems, okay?
We're literally classic because 25 years is considered a classic.
Oh.
Car and, like, music. So.
Yeah, so there you go.
Classic bitches.
Yeah. Give me that AARP. Damn it. I require discounts.
But what do you say, like, as a kid?
Oh, yeah. Like, so as a kid, it's probably half and half. Like, as a kid, you when you play video games, it's like, oh, it's so cool, and your imagination kind of goes with it. So
yeah.
You could just give me like an 8-bit character, and I'm gonna imagine everything about what they look like, mm-hmm. even if there's not all those details.
Yeah.
I mean, grown people do that too, but I think it's more so when you're a kid. Okay. But like, I think about games I played when I was a kid,
mm-hmm.
and I'm like, oh, it was, like, so cool. There were so many details, and it was, like, mm-hmm. it was, like, 1080, and it was HD. It was 4K back then, you know?
Yeah.
They were real people, and then you go and look at gameplay, and it's,
oh,
like, a stick figure.
Like,
yeah.
I
feel like
to,
I'm shouting. I'm going
to
just do this so that I can hear myself, because I feel like I'm shouting.
No. I watched gameplay of, like, Super Mario 64, and it looks real laggy, honestly, a little bit. Like, I mean,
yeah.
At the time it was crazy good, but
yeah.
It just seemed like, and maybe it's just because somebody's recording it on their laptop or whatever, and then it.
Yeah, that's a big thing, because the technology gap. Like, our technology is so advanced now
mm-hmm.
that it doesn't have the ability to slow down that much.
Yeah.
It's like going to school and majoring in math, like going to college and majoring in math, and then trying to do fucking fractions or something.
Yeah. It's funny, like back then we didn't even care about, like, well, there weren't really like crazy glitches, or if they were, we didn't really notice it because the game kind of looked like a glitch.
Oh yeah, this is the whole game was
but
a glitch.
Like, now our days, like, games literally look like this, like just people, like,
yeah,
movies. And, like, there'll be, like, one time maybe your character, like, is, and we're like, fuck this game! It's
yeah.
fucking trash!
Yeah. I need a refund. This one's glitchy.
Yeah, it's freezing.
Yeah.
but it's crazy how much we've came. But,
yeah.
Anyway, but, like, back to the PlayStation. I had the PlayStation 1. Played Harry Potter, the Rugrats game.
I loved that game so much.
Oh,
I love that game so much. And I made the mistake, like, a couple weeks ago, looking up gameplay of it, because I was like, I miss it. I want to have it in my memory again.
Yeah.
And it was literally, like, Tommy's head is, like, a fucking, like,
it's a square.
Yeah.
Square. Yeah.
And I was like, no, this isn't what the real game looks like.
Yeah. It's cool. They did really well with, like the house, because it was kind of, like, a semi-open world.
Yeah.
Just your backyard and
yeah.
your house, which is cool, because that's all the babies know. Like,
yeah.
Episode went
to it was so cool. I remember, like, the balloons, like, when everything
mm-hmm.
turned upside down, and you had the balloon mini game,
and
Reptar, you had to, like, find something in the house.
I remember there was one where my least favorite mission, I don't know, God, it's been so long. I literally just know the characters, and you had to place the dog one time, Spike.
Yeah.
Yeah. But there was one, like, I think you placed Chucky. But you had to control, like, the little airplane or something. That was my least favorite part. It was so
I don't remember that one. I only remember a few of them, though, but
yeah
that was my shit. That, and I had a Barbie Genie for Game Boy, and that was my tea. Is that how you say that? That was my tea.
Oh my God.
That was my shit. I loved that game,
yeah.
man. It was so cool.
I had the Spirit game, the horse.
Oh,
Spirit.
I never had that one.
You played as fucking Spirit.
You were a horse, and that's it.
You weren't like the Indian people.
Okay, Tina Belcher.
The Native Americans. But, like, you weren't, like, them, like, taking care of the horses. You were fucking Spirit. The
oh.
horse walked around eating fucking apples.
That's hilarious. That's all you do. Yeah, I liked anything that was like anything that you had to. There was any secrets you had to discover, or you know, just any sort of explorative game.
Yeah,
I've always loved that kind of stuff. But
I guess I really got into. I love like action adventure now. Like that's my shit.
Yeah.
And I guess it kind of evolves with how I played throughout the year.
Look what I found, guys. It's
oh!
a kitty. Say hi, Marie. She's like, fuck you guys. Okay.
Now we got a million views because there's a cat on it.
Yeah. you damn straight out putting that in a tag. Kitties. Well, there are plenty. I got kitty. mug and a kitty shirt.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I love that cat shirt.
It's pushing.
And he has a headset on.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I matched so many things. I didn't even realize.
Yes.
Okay. Anyways.
No, you're fine. But, like, my PlayStation 1, and this is, I know I'm going to say that, and I'm like, well, it's because that the game's coming out. But anyway, I played Spyro, like, nothing
else.
Spyro was my shit.
Yes.
And those were the first games in my whole childhood that I actually beat by myself.
Yes. You're right. I did beat Spyros. Yeah. I had Spyro, the first game I ever completed, like, did a complete completion run of, was, I can't remember which one it was, but it was the Spyro for the one that, the Game Boy that pops up like that.
Oh.
I collected everything. I got all the little...
Shit, I played that too.
Completely racist guys that steal things. Do you guys remember that?
Yeah, like the Indian
they were
dude,
so racist. He had, like, had his face covered up and he had a turban. It was like, wow, that's fucking racist.
You know they changed the look of him now?
Did they?
Spyro's coming out this year.
I was going to bring that up. They're remastering it, right? So they're not doing a remake. They're doing a remaster.
They just, like, crashed it. Like, so it's going to be the original games, like Crash was, but they're going to...
So excited
like,
for that.
Maybe missions they never did in PlayStation 1.
So excited. I saw a video of that, and they, like, compared the two, where it was, like, blocky and everything, and now it's, like...
But did you know... I don't know if you noticed, but, like, they actually changed the look of that guy, I guess because, like, that's what...
No, I didn't notice that in the game, but yeah. Like, I
think he just has, like, a little wizard's hat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't notice that when I was a kid, but, you know, after I grew up, I realized, oh...
Just because I want to know what the titles were called, because... I don't want to just call them Spyro 1, 2, and 3, because they were they had, like, actual titles, but I can't remember them. I know it was, like, the rage of...
I loved Spyro. Like I said, I loved anything that was exploration, that you had to collect stuff,
and
discover stuff.
It was a great game to begin with as a kid, because there was that, like, you had to collect, like, the gems.
The gems, Mr. Moneybanks.
And the first one you had to... release the bigger dragons because they became all stone and you're the only one that wasn't. So
yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, so I think that was a great one for like kids to definitely start on because it wasn't like punishable when you died either. Which I still, as an adult, I hate games that are like really like they fucking punish the fuck out of you.
Type in like Spyro 2018. That'll probably help. It'll give you like what they're remastering. So I was gonna, later on in the video, I want to talk about some games that are coming out, either this year or TBA, and just a couple of them. And I was gonna actually talk about Shadow of the Colossus, but I realized it came out March, so decided not to put that one on there.
No,
February or March, one of the two.
Yeah.
So I decided not to put that one on there, because it already came out, so. I remember playing the original one, and on, what was it, PS... PS3?
It came out on PS2.
PS2.
And then they had it come out again, if I'm not mistaken, for PS3.
Oh, okay.
Like, I don't know if it was a complete remaster, or if they just, like, I don't know what it was, really. But I know they did it again for the PS3, and then, of course, now we have the remaster on PS4.
Yeah, so I remember playing it. I never completed that one, but I did play a little bit of the beginning of it, because it wasn't mine, it was... No! Okay. We're still recording. Okay. I've had so much trouble with my computer today. It's ridiculous. it wasn't my game, so I didn't get to finish it, but I did play the beginning of it, and I thought it was a really cool concept. So, they are remaking that. They remade it. They didn't remaster it. They remade it.
Yeah, they completely, like, re-amped it. Like,
yeah.
Because I saw, like, a video on it, and they said they actually, like, made the controls better, they moved everything out. It's basically a whole different experience, they say, so I think that's what they're going to do with Spyro. I never played the Crash Bandicoot remastered because, to be honest, I hated Crash when I was a kid.
I never played it either. I played it a little bit, but it was like...
It's rage, man. It's a rage.
Yeah, I wasn't, I don't know, I wasn't too into it. It was very,
I kind of like the character, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, like, what I remember from Crash is that it was just, like, it was a very linear game. Like, it was kind of like a racing game, but cartoony.
Yeah.
You know, and I.
Like, yeah, you go by. You have to go against the clock, and I don't like.
Yeah,
games
yeah.
Like that. I still don't like games like that. There's actually.
I liked the fact that Spyro had some of that in it. Like it was like mini games to complete stuff.
Yeah, it did.
But it wasn't the whole game.
Right. So this is what the Spyro games are called. So Spyro the Dragon was the first one, and then the second one was called. Riptoes Rage.
I remember that one. Oh my gosh! And then, like, the finale was you.
Year of the Dragon.
Yeah.
And that's when you could skateboard. Remember the skateboard scene?
I don't know if I played that one actually. I think I just played the first two.
I used to like. Oh god. I used to play that third one all the time because they give you like more stuff you could do, like that, like you could skateboard and. You can actually swim because, of course, remember, like, the first Spyro, like, you hit water, like, when you drowned.
Yeah, yeah.
But the third one, you could swim.
Yeah.
I loved it. Yeah. But I love Spyro, and that was the first game I ever beat as a kid. And I actually beat those multiple times. I was a kid.
Yeah, yeah, I remember those. Those were a lot of fun. So, like, my favorite console of the original generations... Joe's about to come home. Let me close this door. Oh, the thing's
in there. There's a cat in the door.
I've done that before in accident when I'm trying to close the bathroom door and I don't know they're there. Like, I've closed it, like, the hinge of it closes on their tail and they freak out. But I don't do it on purpose. I swear to God I don't. I do not abuse my cats. They're all very healthy, happy, and chubby. If they go to the vet, they're beautiful and they get taken care of. You want out now? Go on. But anyways, my favorite consoles of the first generations-ish, like between, see, I started with a Nintendo 64 too.
Mm-hmm.
It was my stepdad's and I had, actually had it on like a cart, like I had one of those big box TVs.
Yeah.
And then I had it on, I don't know why, but we had this food cart thing and I put the TV on top, and I put the Nintendo 64 on the bottom, and then I would put it in my closet when I wasn't using it and pull it out. And
uh-huh.
Yeah, so, fun fact, I guess, I don't know. But I had Donkey Kong Country, I think?
I've never played a Donkey Kong game.
Ever. I had Donkey Kong for that, and I had another Donkey Kong game for Game Boy. Yeah. Never beaten a Donkey Kong game.
Really?
I've never beaten it. They are so hard, dude. Like, the one I had for my Game Boy, I gave up on. And, like, over the years, I've lost my Game Boy and all my games. I don't know where they went, but...
I know, right?
From all the times I've moved and everything, it's sad, but it's true.
I found my Game Boy Advance, but I couldn't find any all of my games for it.
Yeah.
I have a Rocket Power game.
Nice.
For it?
But yeah. Squid?
Squid, that was the...
Squid was the kid. Little nerdy dude.
Yeah, he was the...
he was the short guy.
Town,
yeah. And he had the shark helmet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome. Before shark helmets were even a thing. If I was a
Are
kid,
they
though,
a thing now? Are they cool?
Yes, like people have like those ones that look like they have like mohawk.
Oh, yeah, I've seen those,
and,
yeah.
Like, shark, like, yeah. There's a
yeah.
If I was a kid, I would have rocked one of those helmets out instead of not wearing a helmet.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Original merch.
Yeah. So you had Donkey Kong?
Yeah, so I had Donkey Kong, and I never finished that.
It was hard.
Yeah. The one for Game Boy was really, really, really hard. Like, I want to say like 3/4 of the way through the game, and then there was this one level that I just could not beat, so I literally just fucking physically flipped the table and was like, I'm done. I'm done with this.
Oh my god.
Rage quit.
I think that would be a good one to talk about. Like, what was our, like, one of our first, like, major games that we started raging? Like, what we discovered
was. Definitely Donkey Kong was for me, was
really?
A first. Yeah, and then, so, like, all the consoles that we had growing up, I have 5 brothers and sisters, so. We didn't have, big family. We didn't have money to buy a system for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
So my stepdad bought systems, and then we would play them sometimes in the evening for like an hour.
Well,
they had to regulate. Yeah, they had to regulate us because Crystal and I, my sister, she would We would take turns playing like single player games, and we would play them for hours.
Really?
Like we would play nonstop, so they had to take them away.
See, I have my two stepsisters and one real sister, and only one of the stepsisters actually lived with me, and the other ones would visit every weekend or whatever, however that schedule went. But I was the only one who gamed, like, so
Yeah.
I didn't have to really worry about sharing. But whenever some of them started like getting interested in what the big sister was the one, because I'm the oldest out of all of them,
Yeah.
I was like such a fucking punk kid, dude. I'd be like, no, they're gonna mess it up, they're gonna mess up my save. I was that kid, like,
Yeah,
no.
yeah. Well, Crystal and I, like, we were kind of like on the same wavelength when it came to. So, like, what we would do is we would take turns playing until one of us got bored or one of us got like ragey, and then
Yeah.
we would switch. And you know,
Give me
this
a
was
break.
before Google. This was before any internet. We didn't have any internet. We didn't have a computer, or any of that stuff. So we did like we played Ocarina of Time too on the 64,
Whoa.
and we didn't, you know, we didn't have Google to figure out a walkthrough or any of that,
Not at
so
all.
it was hard for us.
Yeah, the only time I remember of discovering, like, because there was used to be cheat codes for stuff, and
Yeah.
remember those days? It's not even really a thing anymore with
No,
cheat
it's
codes.
not.
Like, there's like, you
Whoops.
know, secret ways to, I don't know, I guess beat things. Because I know that Far Cry 4, if you just sit there, you'll beat the game in 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there's not really cheat codes. They're not like, you know,
Yeah, people
super.
do speed runs of stuff now, but I
Yeah.
mean, speed run like a speed run of getting over it, there's no cheating to it. They
No,
just
that's
like
actually,
find.
that's them being really good at
Yeah, that's
something,
just
and
them
that's
being
cheating,
really
because that's
good. I mean,
definitely
I'm
cheating.
sure there are. I don't like cheat codes and stuff like
Yeah.
that. Now, when I was a kid, I was like,
Right.
give me the best way, the easiest way.
The only time I really used cheat codes was for Grand Theft
Yeah.
Auto. Because
Well,
that
I
one.
thought it was really cool because, like, my brother, so conjoined family, so I didn't have all those siblings growing up. But my blood brother is six years older than me, so he was a teenager when I was a kid, and he would get cheat codes for like Resident Evil and Silent Hill and stuff like that.
What
And
did they
I
do
thought
for
that
you?
was super cool. It would be like it would unlock like certain
Guns
weapons,
and shit.
because with Resident Evil and Silent Hill, you have to reach like achievements, like you have to reach steps to get certain items.
Yeah.
So you have to do a full playthrough of the game on a
And then
certain
unlock it.
level, and then you get a really cool weapon, or then you get an
What are your
outfit.
thoughts on that? What games that do that? Do you like
I think
them?
it's really cool. I think it makes it replayable.
I get that, but I wish I kind of had that stuff when I played it the first time.
Yeah, but like, okay, so Silent Hill, for one, the original three Silent Hill games are my favorite games of all time. Like, I will replay
I
them over and
think
over.
the only one I've ever tried to play is The Room, and
The Room
it's
is shit.
oh, okay, so I played the shit one. It's
No.
so hard though. It's just
I didn't like The
not.
Room. There's mixed reviews about it. But
Yeah.
people who like Silent Hill, mostly, most people who like Silent Hill like the original three.
Yeah.
Because after the third, might have been after the fourth one, but I want to say it was after the third one. The original, they called themselves Team Silent. The original developers broke up and a different.
Yeah.
Bitch, stop going to sleep on me. The original developers, Team Silent, broke up after the first few games, and so new developers came in to take over. So a lot of the concepts of the original games didn't, like, the original Silent Hill games, I think were beyond their time. They were so detailed in
Yeah.
everything,
Well,
each monster.
they have, I mean, iconic monsters that
Yeah.
still are iconic today, and people cosplay like Pyramid Head and shit like
Yeah,
that all the
each
time.
monster, and one of the awesome things about Silent Hill is that they, it's not like straightforward, like the storyline and what everything means isn't straightforward. You have to find the pieces and
To
put it
everything.
together yourself. And it's like, so a lot of the monsters, all the monsters in the first three at least, mean something to each character. So like
Like
Silent
heresies and
Hill,
stuff. Like.
yeah. Silent Hill, and then there's a whole like deity and like gods and all kinds
Yeah.
of
It's
stuff
pretty
behind it.
satanic, like, what
Yeah,
that game is.
it's
It's
crazy.
really, like, because But like I said, I played The Room. I gave up.
I have 2 and 3 remastered.
Yeah.
And you need to play them because they're fucking scary. They still scare the shit out of me. I know what's going to happen. I know where all the monsters are. I've played it over and over and it still scares the shit out of me.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's so good.
I know this happy world, like, oh, shut up. But, like, I watched the movie, the first one. The second one's garbage. But,
yeah.
The first movie, it's pretty fucking rough. But, like, it's.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. Like, it's, yeah, it's got a. It's got a good bit of gore too, a little bit of sprinkle of some gore in there.
I love the movie.
I can't watch the ending where they, spoiler alert, well, there's, whatever, it's a lot of spoilers.
They gave him, like,
yeah, whatever. We're talking about old shit, okay. So if you haven't caught up yet, then that's your problem. It was the early 2000, let me guess, 2000, I'm going to say 2009? 2011.
Really? No.
Maybe not that early.
No.
Or not that late.
Because the second one came out 2012.
Oh. Yeah, so like, it was a couple of years difference.
That second one was awful.
It was good if you didn't know anything about Silent Hill. It was okay.
Yeah, I mean,
because it had a lot of cool characters and stuff.
That guy, like, the acting in that one was...
I just mean, like, the special effects and the monsters and stuff were pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, because that chick that's, she plays... In Matrix, she plays the one with the
sleeve. Trinity!
Thank you. But, like, yeah,
I don't know her real name, but she'll be Trinity forever in my heart.
I don't know her real name, but I don't
even... I don't care what her real name is. She's Trinity. I love The Matrix so much. Oh, yes.
I never could get into it because...
I love them.
But Travis used to love it. 2006, bitch, that's what I'm
saying. Oh, damn.
Oh! But anyway, yeah, so it gave him, like, more than, like, 12 years.
Yeah, you need to catch up if you don't know what we're talking about.
Yeah. She was super hot, that
bot. She was definitely had that pink-esque.
Yeah, she was
pink,
like,
with a exclamation point.
Boots, like, as a cop, really.
Yeah.
I don't know, cop, but,
yeah, she was super cool, but apparently she did nothing because she still got caught.
Yeah, because she was
by normal people. She didn't even die by monsters. She died by normal people.
Yeah,
but I guess
like
that's
or
yeah. So the thing, like, the second movie's really shitty because it doesn't follow. It doesn't follow the concepts of the games, and I can't stand. Like, it's one thing, okay, it's one thing to me if a movie is made from a book and the movie is different from the book, because it's two completely different forms of media,
yeah.
Right? So, you can't, like, the movie is always going to be a, what's the word, like a different, like a...
It's definitely made from a different view.
Yeah, because you can't include everything that's in a book. Not because a movie can't be made long enough, but just because there's... Not everything is dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
So, I understand that. But when you make a movie from a video game, like, you have no excuse.
Yeah, because, I mean, like, especially these days, like, I can understand, like, you're trying to make, like... A goddamn, like, Donkey Kong movie. Like,
yeah.
You have to put some type of story, because there's not... I mean, I'm sure there is. I'm sure some very troll, like, there's a story to Donkey Kong. Like, but I don't see one. But, like, if someone had to, like, they would actually have to give it a story. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Like, Angry Birds. Like, Angry Birds is a kind of story. Not really. Like, there's pigs that stole their
eggs. A movie of them, isn't there?
Exactly. So, like, they had to make, like... But,
I don't know.
I haven't seen it.
Some
of these, but, like... Like, Halo and Silent Hill, like, they already give you that story, like you said. Like, they already give you, like, there you go.
Yeah, if you're making a movie.
People and CGI monsters or CGI, like, aliens, and it's easy.
Like, you're making a movie out of that video game because you already know that it's a popular video game. That's the only reason you're going to make a movie out of it. So, why try to change it so that you think that changing it's going to bring in a bigger fan base? Like, just stick to the fan base it already has. Like, don't change it.
I think we should definitely talk about this in like another video, but like talking about maybe video game movies and how they're all garbage. Almost all of them are garbage. But I guess the only ones that are probably kind of critically acclaimed is the Resident Evil movies, but they're still shit too.
They're shit. I like to look at Resident Evil movies in a completely different, like, in my head, they're not Resident Evil.
Exactly. If you just took that title
if
out
they
and just called it like... Apocalypse
just zombie bitches. I don't know.
Yeah,
just anything different.
Because it's not Resident Evil.
No, it's not. No. Like, you could literally, they could have called it something completely different and still had cameos of Resident Evil characters, and then the audience would have been like, whoa, it's a crossover from this universe to the Resident Evil universe, so, like, and that would have been like, way so cooler.
Like, maybe like almost like a spin-off from the Resident Evil.
Yeah, universe, if they would have, like, they could have done a spin-off, or they could have done, like, you know, something like, this is the zombies in the other part of the world,
yeah,
in the same universe.
Alice
is not a thing.
They don't even have goddamn zombies in the movie. Like, I mean, there is, but that's not what it's about. Like, it's not.
Alice is not even a thing.
No,
I love the first three movies up until Extinction, the one where they're like in the desert and they go to.
I've literally watched one.
Well, I like the, but I think of them, they're not Resident Evil in my head.
Not Resident Evil 1. I've watched, like, one of the.
No, they're not at all. They're not at all.
But I saw a lot of, like, clips and stuff of it.
I love Resident Evil 1 because it has, Michelle Rodriguez in it, and I love her so much.
Which one would be your favorite?
My favorite?
Of, like, those movies.
Of those
which
movies.
Shit?
Of those movies not being part of Resident Evil, I like Extinction the most because you can catch me with flashy things. I like flashy things. It's this one where they're she's in the desert, like the zombies have taken over the world. The desert retook everything.
That literally looks the coolest, I'd say.
I think it's so cool because like the visual effects are awesome. The colors in the movie are really cool. Her outfit's bomb. Like she's so badass. She's the most badass in that one. She's got like a trench coat thing. She's wearing shorts and fucking holsters everywhere.
Nice.
She's
like,
got
so, like,
two
she got
like two like machete. Yeah, the machetes, I think. Two machetes that she fucking tears people up with. I'm like, yes, it's my bitch.
You know who I always thought.
Oh, and she has superpowers too. She can like.
That's right. Because she has that like shit in her body, right?
Yeah,
that,
she like, has the T virus in her.
That's it.
And then, but at the end of the, it made me so mad. Because they fucking, that's the only movie that she has that she brings out her powers and she, like, uses her mind, her Jedi mind tricks.
The only one I've ever saw was called Afterlife and she had it in that too. Or she had it out and she was trying to get it back in.
It was at the end of, either at the end of Extinction or the beginning. Afterlife is the next one after that.
Yeah.
Or at the beginning of Afterlife, one of the two. But she confronts Wesker.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's the beginning of Afterlife, I think, where she confronts Wesker and he takes off in his private plane or whatever, and she's in there, and he like injects her with the cure, and she's like, oh, thank you. Oh.
Yeah.
And you know, I hate that so bad because she had just gotten badass the movie before. She had just, like, gotten to her peak of badassery.
Yeah.
And then they take it away.
Yeah.
But I think the reason why they did that was so that they could show that she could still be badass without her powers. She could still kick ass. But it's not the same.
Yeah.
Like, come on.
Afterlife came out in that, like, movie era where, like, they didn't care about dialogue or plots. They just cared about making the movie 3D. Because it was it was the first 3D movie.
Oh, was it?
Yeah. Yeah, it was like Avatar, like 3D, and that was like that time where like Avatar was. I love Avatar, but it was in that era where even comedies were being like 3D. Like, go see the 3D.
You need to stop. 3D. It's not okay.
Yeah.
Are you aware of people who have glasses? Do you know that it's not fun to watch 3D with glasses on your glasses?
That's so true.
Oh
yeah.
God, I keep like smacking this.
That's when like that movie came out and they, like I said, like they don't care about like dialogue, so they probably fucked up, you know.
Yeah.
Afterlife because of they were just trying to get that like $13 a ticket money.
Yeah, and I was like with. I really, really, really try to stick with something. Once I become a fangirl of it, I try so hard to fight for it and you know advocate for that fandom.
Yeah.
So. Through Afterlife, I was like, no, guys, it's going to get better. I promise.
Right.
It's going to get better. So, I think it was the next one. No, the one after that, two movies later, there's a lot.
They just finished, I know the last one.
You can Google it.
That last one got great by reviews.
I did not watch the last one. I gave up. By the time the last one came out, I gave up on it.
But apparently, it was supposed to, like, kind of go back to that extinction. But I heard it.
So, Extinction was my favorite one. And then...
Man, look how... Look how early 2000s that first picture is. Like,
right?
That looks like a Mandy Moore.
That's insane.
That means it's, yeah.
Yeah, after so.
What was that newest one called? The Final.
The Final Chapter. Resident Evil Retribution. That one was. I think it was that one. That one was shit. Whatever one where they tried to make it, they tried to go back to their roots and make it look more like the video game, but they did so bad. Everything was in like slow, everything was in slow motion. And it was
dinner and she still hasn't like
yeah. Everything was in slow motion and they did like really bad, the worst fucking fight sequences you've ever seen in your life. It was literally like move your head.
Oh yeah. Sorry.
Like that! Like, it was just like, this is slow motion, and she's not even, like, touching the person. It was like, what the fuck? And then, like, they had, like, really, like, retro audio over top of it.
Interesting.
Like, they were trying to, I don't know, it was so bad. It was so bad. It was so bad. I don't even know how we got on the fucking Resident Evil movies, but.
We were talking about Silent Hill because we were talking about the favorite system.
Yeah. So my early, I never even said my fucking favorite system. Favorite, my favorite system from like the original systems,
I'm really
or whatever,
on this, is all over the place. Like, I mean, you play everything. Not like
yeah, everything. I would say it's probably the PS2 is probably my favorite.
I was gonna say I haven't even said mine either. But
oh yeah,
no, it's fine.
There you go, guys. 40 minutes into the video, there you go.
I tell you, like PS2.
So many good games.
It's still, to this day, the most sold system. Like, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's still as outsold the PS4.
Oh, I love
it's
it.
Crazy. And
it's
the PS4,
so great.
And of course, it's done great. It's done really, really well.
Yeah.
But it still hasn't beat its little tiny PS2. Like,
it's little tiny.
Yeah.
Compact little baby.
What was your favorite PS2 game?
Silent Hill.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah. I loved it. I loved it so much.
That's cool.
The first three Silent Hill and the first three Resident Evils were my favorite, and they still are my favorite.
Yeah. You know what I love about that era? Fucking demo discs.
Yes.
Those anymore, but like,
yeah. Or like the really long. I remember Matrix. Well, we had Matrix for one of the PlayStations, two or three, I can't remember. And then we also had Matrix for GameCube. Hey, throwback.
Man,
and it was like
Matrix.
Four discs long.
Some people fucking hated that game, but like, back to Travis, but like, he played that game like crazy, and it was fucking awesome. It was a great game.
Yeah,
it was,
I really.
Like, slow motion shit.
Yeah, I thought it was
you
really cool.
Play as, Janet Pickett Smith's character. What's her name? You remember like the.
Naomi.
Yes. You got to play as her, or you can play as Neo, of course. But I love playing
my
as
name
in those high heel, like, those
is
things.
Neo.
And you like.
Yeah.
And you like flip. A lot of people hated it. Like,
it was super cool.
Awful. Like, no, that game was really fun. And I hate Matrix. Sorry. I don't know.
That's okay.
I never watched. Well,
I like
I
stuff.
Tried.
I like anything that has a good concept behind
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Yeah.
A good story. Anything that makes you think.
I guess I could try
about things.
I was a kid, but it just. I really don't like Keanu Reeves as an actor.
I mean, that's fair. He's kind of monotone.
Yeah,
he's pretty monotone. He has, like, the same character that in every movie that he plays in. So
yeah.
I get that. He has a cool name.
Yeah, Neo. He's the one.
Yeah. No, I mean, like, Keanu Reeves
oh.
is a cool name.
Yeah, Keanu Reeves is cool. I guess. What is his nationality?
I used to want to get.
Asian, right?
I used to want to get a bulldog. Is he? He might be. He might be half Asian. He's not full blooded.
No,
Asian.
Definitely not full. Like, there's definitely some like.
I'm not sure.
White ass in there.
Yeah. I used to want to get a bulldog and name him Keanu, just because I love that name, and I think it'd be cute for a dog. Keanu. Oh, Keanu, come here. It's time to get your little treat.
Slow motion, like,
yeah. throw a ball at him, and he does the fucking.
Oh my god.
Like that horse video. Do you remember that?
Oh, shit.
You're the horse, like, the lady's on the horse, and the horse, like, rears up and then just fucking suplexes her and, like, falls back on her.
Yeah. Body slam, basically.
Yeah.
So PS2, I've got to give PS2 a lot of credit for me, too, because I guess I would. I'm kind of a millennial on that fact, because I. Oh, that's sad when that's like your exercise.
Oh yeah, it's so hard. Oh.
So both of us went to Sony, which is fun.
That's yeah, fun. Well, you know, when we were growing up, that was all you had. You had Sony and you had Nintendo, but Nintendo's kind of always been a step behind the cool
like,
kids.
I know you're like you're into Legend of Zelda now, but like
yeah.
I've just never
That's the only thing I yeah. like about Nintendo. Yeah. I mean, well, another game that I played when I was a kid was Mario Sunshine, but...
Oh, I love that.
And that was on GameCube, though. Yeah. Which was by Nintendo, right? The GameCube?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Nintendo system. Oh, yeah, there's no way Nintendo will let anyone else have Mario. That's their base.
Yeah, yeah. That was a that was a big rage game for me. Like, yeah. Donkey Kong was the first one, but Mario Sunshine...
Yeah, I don't think I ever beat it.
Okay. No, I've never beaten it.
Yeah.
Crystal and I, again, this was a time before Google, so we didn't know how many shine sprites there were. We thought there was like, yeah, we got to like 74, and we were like, oh, man, there's one left. We've almost beaten it. Mm-hmm. And so there's this one, the one little island off the main island where you have to take Yoshi there by boat. And then you have to get him to eat the stuff in the tunnel. It's really hard to do. Like, just to get to the level, took us hours just to get to the level.
Yeah. You know that's one of the most hated Mario games?
I'm not surprised. It's hard.
It's weird, though. I mean, I liked it the best, honestly. See, all the Mario games I like are the open world. I don't like
the people who hate it is the people who got their ass whooped by it. That's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is. Yeah. It's not because it was a bad game. It was because it induces so much rage.
Yeah.
So much rage. I want to do gameplay of that eventually whenever I get a capture card that will support GameCube.
GameCube controller.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we have a GameCube, but we also have a Wii, because the original Wii's supported GameCube games.
I never played
the
Wii that much.
Yeah, me either. It's like, any new concept of a console, when it first comes out, you know you need to wait at least one more generation to buy that, because it's going to be shitty. Like, when the Wii came out with the...
Like, you think you need to wait until, like, that next console comes out to get that last one?
No, to just skip like that console and get the next one, unless you collect consoles like we do, but you know, because like new concept as in like motion sensor, when motion sensor first came out, it was so cool and it was so awesome, but it was so glitchy. It was so glitchy. Yeah, it was really glitchy and it was like really it was really based on, like, motion sensor that we have now, it was really archaic.
That's, like, this fucking thin.
Yeah.
And not stable. Not stable at all.
Yeah.
It's literally on a cord that's, like...
Yeah.
And our, this, like, fucking long.
Yeah. Our Wii U sensor is pretty big. We bought one, and it's, like, that wide and, like, that tall. It's pretty big.
Is it the one that you could put batteries in? Or you could put...
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that one's... I feel like ones that are a little bit, like, thicker. I just feel like they're more stable.
Yeah.
The little tiny ones, like...
Yeah.
A hop, which requires you to if you play any of those motion ones.
Yeah. And, like, we have a flat screen, but it's kind of... It's outdated for TV. So it has the big plastic around the edge of the screen, and... For a flat screen, it's pretty thick.
Yeah.
For a flat screen. So, it's easy to just Velcro that sensor on top.
Yeah.
Even though, you know, most people are not going to want to put sticky Velcro on their TV. But, you know, we can do that because there's a little bit of a platform to do that. But if you have a TV, if you go on Walmart now and you buy a TV, a flat screen, you're not going to be able to just stick Velcro.
Right.
It's not going to fit.
Yeah. For sure.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
I didn't mean to misgender you.
He wanted to join us. Here's to Woos. Hey. It's to Woos, our baby.
You can do like a zoom in and like cut.
It's his face. Hi.
Oh my god. I love that. Yeah, I'm just not into the Wii at and all. That was yeah. almost, like, I feel like that was, like, for little kids, almost.
Yeah. Like, but I knew, like, when it first came out, I knew it was going
to
be really...
And, like, 40-year-old woman who only wanted to play Wii Fit.
Yeah, like, what even is that? But, like, now with the VR systems, they're really cool, and they are a lot more high-tech than the Wii sensors, obviously. But they're still...
It's the same thing, though. I haven't built...
Like, it's not going to be...
The PlayStation camera.
Yeah, but it's, like... Give it a few years and it's going to be way better than what
oh,
it is
sure.
now.
Like, for sure. They're actually, I think they're already improving on, like, the PlayStation
yeah.
VR. Because the only thing about the PlayStation VR, I love it a lot. They said they're actually going to make about, like, 100 games for it this year. So, they're making more games. So, I'm not going to go ahead and, I'm not going to say, like, oh, there's not enough games for it. Because, just give it time, it will.
Mm-hmm.
I just wish it was a little bit more user-friendly. Because it's not, like... It's super complicated to, like, I can't just bring it over and put it on your PlayStation. Like, I could, but it takes a while.
Yeah.
To, like, hook it up.
Yeah.
And you have to, like, calibrate it. And
yeah. And the graphics are pretty shitty. Like, if you compare the graphics to just a regular PS4 game.
Right. It really does bring down the,
It brings down the experience, I think.
What's it called? The fucking, frames per second. That's
yeah.
It really does.
FPS.
yeah. But yeah. I'm like, when I see it being played, it looks good. But
yeah.
of course, on your head, it's not. But I mean, I understand, I guess, you know, it's not there yet. And it would be a lot more expensive if they had it, like.
Well, by the time they get to that point, it'll probably be the same.
Right.
$300-$400 yeah, like, or whatever.
The Vive, which apparently is so pretty and so much better, it's $799. Like, it's a lot of money. $799.
Yeah, but it's probably still not at the level of regular games.
Yeah, I think so, but I think its graphics are honestly a little bit better than
yeah.
PlayStation. Just because it's
so do you think easy. You think we're going to keep going towards that VR virtual reality way of playing games, or do you think it's going to be kind of a little bit of a flop like previous systems?
Like the Vita?
Yeah, like the Vita or the GameCube was discontinued.
Or, like, yeah, like the Wii Fit
kind or of yeah, the Wii. Nobody really does
so
Wii.
More, yeah, like the interacting with your games. Like, no, I honestly
yeah.
think the VR is going to keep going. I really do. I think that's going to. Because.
I think it's almost a little bit beyond its time.
Yeah.
You know?
I think it's going to keep going just because.
Before its time. Before its time. That's what you're supposed yeah. to say. Beyond its time!
Yeah. No, I think it's going to keep going because. Where am I going with this? I think it's going to because it's already like a really cool like party
yeah.
game kind of thing. Like, ooh, it scared the shit out of grandma! Like, Resident Evil 7, the first level.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
So it's definitely like a cool social thing.
Yeah.
That I think
hi.
Catch on more. And
he's
if they
back.
Do, if they do more games where it's like Resident Evil 7, where it's, you know, it's pretty long. Because that's the only problem. These VR games are, you can beat them and you beat my,
yeah.
you beat the Impatient in 2.5 hours.
Yeah, I felt bad because
oh,
that was,
okay. you can,
and I was looking at everything too. I was like, what's
yeah.
this poster say? What's this
right,
floor
right.
look like?
I mean, you can play it again and like get different endings and stuff, but yeah, it will be the same outcome. It'll be about 2 to 3 hours. And that's a lot of the VR games. Like,
yeah.
You can beat them in.
Yeah.
Like, honestly.
So, to me, it's, like, cool to have, but it's not something that I want to play all the time.
Yet,
I'd
say this Christmas would be a good time, because it's actually coming down in price. It's, like, went down, like, $100.
Oh, okay.
So it's a good start.
That's cool.
They did come out with the Elder Scroll Skyrim VR, which you could play that. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's gonna be a long time.
He wants cuddles.
Oh, bless its heart. But you can play that game forever, and that's pretty awesome. I would love to see. I know there is like there's a level you can play of the Rise of the Tomb Raider.
Mm.
There's VR levels you can play.
I would love. I'm sure we'll get there eventually, but I would love to see VR go up the next level, and like. Merge Wii type gaming with VR, you know, where
oh.
you use your body.
So that's kind of how like the Vive is.
And you have like you're on like a treadmill that does like 360,
mm-hmm.
not like a treadmill, but like a platform that you buy with the game.
Yeah.
That like moves wherever you move, and you just like strap yourself into it so you don't hurt yourself.
Yeah.
So you literally walk through the game. Anywhere you go, you're physically walking there, and you're, you know, like that would be awesome. It would
be a lot of money,
but but it would be so cool.
Yeah, so you mean like an actual like little mini treadmill, so you
walk. Yeah.
No, that's cool. I just feel like
I mean
it's a little bit more complicated as a user friendly thing.
Yeah, and you'd have to be fit. Yeah, for sure. to be walkable. You have to be able to walk, run.
They have like the, you know, the move controllers, so you have like your hands and stuff that.
Yeah.
That they're putting in a lot of their games, which is cool. And a lot of it, you can't even play it without those move controllers.
Yeah.
Which, just so you guys know, if you have the move controllers from the PS3, it's the exact same thing. Because if you buy them new, it's $100.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Because they knew, like, oh, people get that VR. We
need, yeah. We need to, so they hiked that price up. Yeah.
Like, I love Sony, but some shit like that. Like, oh, come on.
Yeah, but that's...
They have, you know exactly.
That's every game. That's every,
like, company.
Yeah.
Like, but I just think it's funny because it was called the Eye Camera for the PS3, and it went not really anywhere. That, like, the camera for it and the move controllers for it. So it already kind of tried to do this before everyone else did, like Sony did. It just didn't take off the way it wanted it to. But, you know, in, like, their warehouse, there was just a shitload of, like, new controllers, and they just repackaged it. And, like,
yeah.
Got the price.
Yep. Yep.
So, but that's a little life hack for you. If you have them, for some reason, if you got it for the PS3, you can use it on the PS4. So, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that is pretty cool. Yeah. Save some people money, whoever. Like, ha! If you're that person, be like, ha, I knew this was a good investment. Joke's on you, everyone that made fun of me before.
Exactly. Like, the play, even GameStop, if you get a pre-owned, they're still $30 each. That's $60.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the price of a new Xbox One controller.
Exactly. Exactly. And you have to get one of each.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. But I think the VR will catch on more. Like, I think right now, when I worked at GameStop, I literally had questions from people saying, what's VR stand for? Like, people don't even know that
yet. Yeah.
I mean, at least around here. Anyway.
Yeah.
We live
in the middle of nowhere, guys. Definitely. Our town is 6,000 citizens.
Is it?
Residents.
Yeah. Oh.
The whole, whole county has 60,000 people.
Oh. Is that good or bad?
Well, Wichita, Kansas has 400,000 people.
Oh, well.
Just the city itself.
Oh, shit.
And it's a small city. It's pretty small. Hmm. So, I looked it up because one of my friend from previously, I'm not going to say where because I don't need that shit on YouTube. But, yeah, she was thinking about moving here.
Ashley, just because
she's... Because she was bored of where she's living and...
Oh.
Yeah, and her and I are really good friends, so she was like, well, let me move to where you're at. And I'm like, you don't want to do that. Let me tell you why. So I Googled.
40,000 or 60,000 residents?
In the whole county.
Here?
In our whole county, yeah.
And they have 400.
They have 400,000 in their city. Yeah.
Damn, that makes me feel so little. Like,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I always thought that Princeton was, like, decent size.
Right. It's kind of, wow. No. For me to say, like, it's a city. But I guess it's city-ish.
It's a town.
It's a city for fast food.
Yeah. It's a city lots. City of food.
and just cars.
And yeah, there's like,
and cars
two
washes.
Shopping stores here. That's it.
You could get a car and wash it immediately.
Yeah, there's a lot of car washes. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot here. They've been doing a lot of, they've been getting a lot of plazas and stuff. Plazas.
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 Yeah, they're trying to up their game. I see that little,
yeah.
Little fancy.
Trying to make area. It better.
What's that one place called? Like Pita.
The Pita Pit. That just opened. It's like a healthy place. Yeah, I've never been there. We could totally go there. After this, maybe we could go. Anyways,
sorry,
you guys, anybody who's watching this who aren't friends have absolutely no idea what we just spent 10 minutes talking about.
You can look at it, you know.
Yeah.
Google Earth it.
Yeah. on a little speck.
But they probably have like fucking Chipotle. Yeah. I would love to have a fucking Chipotle.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody would love that. Okay. I'm sure there's a lot of people that don't even know what Chipotle is, though.
Right?
Because I didn't know what Chipotle is until I went to and lived in Seattle.
Yeah.
So.
Did you have it? Did you love it?
Yeah, it was great. You're it's like, I always tell people, it's like a Mexican Subway. I'm not trying to be racist, but it's like a Mexican restaurant Subway version of it.
It is, and it's
awesome. You get burritos and burrito bowls, and then you just pick whatever you want.
I literally haven't had it in like 3 years.
I only had it once, I think.
What? So I went to South Carolina.
What the fuck, South Carolina? Let me tell you where you messed up.
South Carolina. We went to the beach, and I was like, oh my god, we should get Chipotle, because we don't have it. Because I will not eat anywhere that we have here, because like, that's a fucking waste.
Yeah.
So,
right? Yeah. If you're going to go on vacation, you need to try different vacation food.
Exactly. I hate it when, like, you go with, like, some...
Let's go to the beach. Now let's go to Wendy's.
Yeah. Fuck you. They have, like, shit we don't have here. They have, like, fresh seafood and fuck. Or, like, and fuck.
No, I would go to a McDonald's in a different country, because they have different things.
Yeah, like, because it's, like, Instagrammable. But then they have, like, well, see, I understand things like that. Like, if you went to, like, a whole different country, even, like, Australia has, like, a better McDonald's.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I get that. But not when you're in the States.
Like, yeah.
I might want to go to...
Okay, so tell us about South Carolina.
Sorry, South Carolina. I went there, and I was like, I'm going to get Chipotle, because I saw it on the way in. And every time you drove by it, it was closed. And it was like at 8 p.m. And that's like a... That's a tourist area, right? Like, what the...
South Carolina, I'm just going to show you my double chin.
From someone who's worked at fast food places before, I think what happened is, like, they're probably those kids that, like... They probably closed at 10, but, like, they shut off, like, all the, like, the lobby lights.
Oh, yeah. Like, nobody's here, guys. Just keep driving.
Exactly. But, yeah, I'm a Chipotle queen.
Yeah. Yeah, I've only ever had it a couple times, but it's pretty good.
But, yeah.
And when I lived in Maryland, they were everywhere, but I never ate at one. Really? And I don't know why, I just never...
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those places you had to commit to, like, either sitting alone and eating alone, or having the time to go in there and actually order.
Yeah, I didn't actually get friends when I went.
It's not like a drive-thru.
When I was in college in Maryland, I didn't actually really start getting friends until, like, the end of my third year. I was really close to my second roommate while we were in college, but then after we left college, she just, like, dropped off the face of the earth. Mm. Which was sad, because I thought we were good buddies, and then she just, like, was just like, okay, bye. Like, everybody at Shepherd, I don't talk to anybody at Shepherd anymore.
That's
yeah. We were in a fraternity. It was not because I'm a man. It's because a fraternity that has boys and girls is called a fraternity. Not because I'm a man.
Because
fraternities are, like, all guys, and then sororities are all girls. But mine was a chemistry fraternity, and it's called a fraternity because there is both male and female.
Right.
So, male domination. Anyways.
I'm just curious, was there more men in that field or more women? Or was it equal?
I don't know, I want to say it was pretty equal.
Oh, well that's
cool. Yeah, there's a lot of geeky people that went to Shepherd.
Oh.
It was a pretty good school. I want to say it's probably about double Concord.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So, anyways, God, we're talking about home again. Okay, gaming!
Let me tell you, PS2, Grand Theft Auto Vice City, I probably spent my whole before I turned a teenager life playing that.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you want to talk about adventure games, I love games with Easter eggs, and that game has yes. tons of Easter eggs.
Yes, I love discovering things in games, and I love it so much.
On, which that's going to be, I have to have like a whole video.
That's not one of my games that I want to talk about, upcoming games, because I knew that that was like, because they're releasing, don't they have something coming out this year?
Who, Horizon? Like Horizon?
Yeah, don't they have like DLC or something?
No, they've already released it. It came out this past December. And I beat it. And you want to hear something? Like, this, it should have been a happy moment, but it was actually really depressing. Actually, just the other day, I went ahead and, like, finished the rest of the quests on Frozen Wilds. And I got a silver trophy for completing every quest in the game, which means I literally have nothing else to do.
Oh no! No!
I even like went to like.
Well, it did phenomenally, so I'm sure they're gonna release another one.
Oh yeah, for sure. Really good. Hurry up, man. Oh, and Gorilla, thank you for liking my picture on Instagram. They actually commented. Like, because I was like, oh my god, Horizon's hit its 1 year, and I said all that mushity-gushity stuff.
And the producers or the...
The actual, like, Instagram page on Instagram. Like, the actual, like, thing.
Oh,
like,
that's so cool! Like,
said thank you for your kind words and put an arrow emoji on it.
Oh, yay!
I was talking about that, but, yeah, Guerrilla Game, man, you guys went from, like, a game I didn't give a shit about to, like, a game that is my life. Because the only thing Guerrilla's known for is the Killzone games.
Yeah.
That's it.
I think... Yeah, when it first came out, you were like, get this game. And then I bought it, and it was awesome, but I wound up returning it because I felt really bad for buying a $60 game.
Oh. Well, now
and we didn't have a lot of money at the time, so I was, like, guilt-tripping myself. Oh, I was like, you shouldn't have done this. You need to go return it. So I returned it.
I feel like, see, of course, like, Horizon Zero Dawn came out literally, like, 3 days before Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
And everyone was like...
Love it.
I played both of them a little... I didn't play as much as Horizon... I mean, of Breath of the Wild... But I feel like it's one of those things, like, because everyone's like, if you love Breath of the Wild, you'll love Horizon Zero Dawn. Or if you love Horizon Zero Dawn, you'll love Breath of the Wild. And to me, they both have things that the other one, like, not needs, but that you definitely, like, you favor things in one game and then you miss it because it was in that game. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I love in Breath of the Wild, you cook. I don't know why. I just love that. And it's cool. And
it gets really tedious after a while, though, because your food is your health, and it's your upgrades, you know?
Yeah.
Because you need stuff when you're fighting fire, you need, like, icy things, mm-hmm. and... Yeah, so it really sucks, because, like, me, I go through the food a lot. I don't know if it's because of my game style.
Me.
Me in real life.
Yeah.
Me IRL. But, no, because, like, I have a habit of just, like, going head first into something and meleeing my way through the mission.
Yeah.
So that's probably the reason why I went through a lot of stuff.
Right.
But
so you just want,
like, it got really tedious after a while to have to go. Because you spend like 30 minutes to an hour
like,
making the food. That's not including going and scavenging it. Because you have to go scavenge everything that you make.
And it's a huge world.
Yeah, it's huge.
Yeah.
It's huge. It blew my mind.
That's, I like that fact about it. But it is very detailed in... sources you need, like clothes and I mean, you can literally you go into that snow part, and if you don't have fucking clothes on, like, you're gonna die.
Yeah,
and I like that. I think it's cool, but I didn't put enough time into it, and I really didn't know where to even find some of the stuff.
Yeah, like, it was really. For me, as a classic Zelda fan, it was really hard to convert over to liking it. Yeah, so, like, the first, you start on the Great Plateau, and that whole arc, I guess you could call it, of the storyline was so hard for me to actually get into the game. Because I was like, this isn't Zelda, no, I'm a purist, it has to be, like, original Zelda, and this is so different, and but once I got past... Once you get the glider and you get
that's
off...
What I was really wanting.
Yeah, once you get that and you get off the Great Plateau... I'm pretty sure it's called the Great Plateau.
I think you're right, yeah.
Yeah, once you get off of that, I don't know. It's just,
it gets
like,
better.
Yeah, it gets better.
Yeah, I need to get past that.
You get horses and stuff. Do you own it?
Not anymore.
Oh.
But, I'll definitely give it a try.
It was my friend's game, so I haven't finished it because...
Yeah, I mean, I had it bought and then... And then I literally was playing and I was just getting so frustrated with it.
You returned it. I was like, fuck this!
I traded it in toward Super Mario Odyssey.
Oh, well, that's a good game too.
Yeah, it's fun.
Also started, never finished. I have a habit of doing that.
I'm a Mario queen.
Yeah. Well, Mario Odyssey is reminiscent for me to Mario Sunshine.
Yeah.
It's nowhere as hard as Mario Sunshine, but you do have to... find all the moons.
Yeah, I like that. I like, and the Mario games that I particularly like the best is the open world.
Yeah,
kind of stuff, because I hate the side scrollers.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I should love that.
Yeah, I mean, they're all right, but I'm never going to choose that over another game.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
No. I don't know. I never liked that kind of game style, really.
Yeah.
I can't think of really a platform game, like a side-scroller that I really liked, honestly.
Yeah, I was never really into that. I don't even like the, the 2D ones where you fight each other, like the arcade-style games. You know what I'm talking about?
Like
Mortal Kombat, yeah. Street Fighter. Like, I don't really like those.
Really?
Yeah.
The only ones I really like, though, is Mortal Kombat and Injustice. Injustice is
amazing. Yeah, I'm not. I'm just, because I guess I'm more of a leisure gamer. Like, I want to go at my own pace and,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
And so, people who play those types of games, they know all the button sequences, mm-hmm. and they're going to kick your ass. No, and it's no fun if you keep losing every time. It's no fun, so. I'm a button masher when it comes to those games, and button mashers never win.
No, I mean, I'm the same way. I mean, there's a few of them I'll try to remember and stuff, but I'm not like that either.
Yeah.
The people that play it for, like, hours just to master, like, the combos and stuff, like,
yeah.
Sorry.
Joe does that.
Oh.
My husband.
He does that.
He's a really big fan of Smash, and Mortal Kombat, a couple years ago, was a really big thing. With him and his mm-hmm. friends, but now he likes Smash up a lot, or Smash, I mean.
Yeah. I wish I liked Smash.
He got so good at Smash that our card shop here, like, they used to have Smash tournaments, and he doesn't do them anymore because he would win every time, and it wasn't fun anymore. Yeah, he's really good at it.
I can name drop it, like.
But that's, like, too much. I can't do that. I can't. Same with Call of Duty. Like, I can't play something for hours, the same thing over and over again, trying to get good at it. It's just, I can't. It's too much of the same thing.
Is he shook that now there's going to be, like, the Smash Brothers for Switch now?
Oh, we don't have a Switch, so.
Well, he's getting one now that that's coming up. You're going to get one.
Well, we need to get one so I can finish Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
GameStop has some pretty cool, like, skins for the Switch.
Yeah.
The Breath of the Wild skins.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty spexy.
Yep.
They're so beautiful.
But, yeah, so Smash Brothers is coming out for the Switch, which that's pretty cool for people that like that.
Yeah.
Hurry up and make the Pokemon game.
Yeah.
I want the Pokemon game so bad. I know. You never play Pokemon.
I've played it here and there, but I didn't play it and I didn't watch it when I was a kid, so it's hard for me to get into it as an adult.
Oh my God, I was way too into it.
Yeah. I had friends growing up that were into Pokemon, but I didn't have, like, my parents never bought that for me, and we didn't have TV growing up, so.
Well, it was definitely, like, it's a way expensive thing to get. So.
Yeah.
My family was not rich at all, but my grandma was, and that's the only one that spoiled me, and now she's nice and peace, like, she's dead now, but she was the only one that spoiled me with that. Like, she would, like, get me, like, a pack, like, she would give me, like, 5 packs of cards, and I have no one. If it's any price back in the early 2000s as it is now, like, she spent probably, comfortably, like, $10,000 on just Pokemon shit. Where is it now?
Yeah.
My Pokemon cards.
Cassandra's Pokemon cards. Where are they now?
Right? I don't even have to think about it, because there's some of those cards that I know are, like, $5,000, $10,000. I don't even want to know how much they are on eBay and stuff, because it would just make me mad. But a lot of my Pokemon cards, when I was moving from a trailer park I used to live for, like, 13 years, I gave them to Travis. It was like a, take care of this, like, passing down.
No.
Like, I don't know, whatever that term is. Passing it down. The torch.
Torch of Pokemon cards.
Because me and him were the only ones that loved it. And I wasn't into it anymore, and, like, at the time, I actually didn't get back into it till, like, 2012, or whenever Pokemon X and Y came out.
When it started getting popular again.
Basically. I mean, I guess Pokemon's never not been popular, but just for me.
It was like a revamp type
thing. Yeah, because I got a 3DS, and oddly enough, what I love about Pokemon is that even if you did play it back in, like, the 90s or early 2000s, and I didn't play it for that many years, you just hopped back right into it, which I kind of love.
Yeah.
So that means they haven't really changed too much, which I love. So they're still, like,
yeah,
pretty true to their source, which is cool. So, you want to get to the videos?
Yeah, we can do that.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, oh God,
you
my feet. I'm gonna some upcoming games I'm really excited about that I wanted to show Cassandra, and I had some information on my phone from just from Wikipedia.
Show that.
But
of my kitty, look at my kitty.
I love it.
No, one of them. That's Marie. But anyways, yeah. So I had collected some information from Wikipedia about, oh damn, about these different games, but then I didn't save it last night, and I didn't realize that I didn't save it, so then I closed out all my apps, and there it went, so I'm just gonna try to find what I saved on my phone as we go, but yeah.
Cool.
So, yeah, go ahead and hit record, or yeah, just press record. And then wait until it, okay. Now go and click, just click on the blue. And then move the mouse to the side. Why is it not playing? Use the clicky mouse. Oh, there it goes. Oh, did you do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Click on the, there it goes. Okay. You can bend it down if it's doing like a weird color thing.
I'm not sure. I'm familiar with this one. I'm very clever. I know it's been out on Steam forever, but it's probably going to come out on console.
Yeah.
It's going to be great. So I'm not a PC person. Unfortunately.
He's like, ah, fuck. All right.
I was actually telling people everyone at work about this game. This one.
Oh. Yay, happy.
I feel like there's gonna be an ad for like a depressive pill.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm very excited about this actually.
Yeah.
Knew about this, should I push pause on
that? We'll wait until
give it a proud mouse.
Yeah. Yes, BSR. Yes, BSR, you do you, boo boo.
Yes. It's actually not coming out.
Yeah, that's false. Anymore, that's false
but
as fuck.
Awesome collector set.
Yeah.
That,
yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright, so I think it's going to automatically play the next video. I don't know why my computer bar is popping up right there. Yeah, just click. Wait. Okay. Add. Skip.
Skip. Oh.
Yeah, skip it. And then click to pause the next one.
This one?
Yeah, just click. No. Click on the video. Click. Just boop. Just click. There we go.
There
okay.
Go.
All right,
cool.
All right. So this was
watched.
We Happy Few.
Yes.
Yeah. So I saw gameplay for this. I didn't know it was a thing until a couple months ago.
Really?
When I was like looking through game compilation videos of like what's up and coming. And I saw it, and I was like, oh, that looks so cool.
So, if I'm not mistaken, that game you can already play. You've been able to play for about a year on Steam. But But now it's coming out as on the consoles, like, so Xbox
One. Yeah, it was released as early access in 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It looks really cool. Everyone immediately goes to, like, oh, it kind of looks like Bioshock, but I've watched gameplay of it. It's not really like Bioshock at all.
Yeah,
it's very, it's survival.
Yeah, it's a survival horror.
Would you call it horror, though?
Well, that's what its technical genre is, survival horror, because you have to scavenge a lot.
Right.
And
yeah.
I'm sure there's a lot of jump scares in it.
Yeah, I'd say there may be a few. Just a little bit of gameplay I've already watched of it. It seems like thriller-esque.
Yeah.
I haven't saw anything that, like, scares me, but it's very much survival instinct kind of. I guess we'll just categorize it as a horror game, but very mild horror, but, unless, you know, there's something that crazy happens that we haven't saw yet.
Yeah, yeah.
It comes up. It looks really cool. I love the concept of it. I love, like, horror games that are, like, 50s style.
Yeah.
I love that. I don't know why.
Yeah.
It's a really cool factor in it. But it looks really cool. I really like the concept of it. I hope the only really, like, the gameplay I've saw of it has been, like, alpha, so it hasn't been polished yet. So hopefully whenever it comes out on the console, it does really well.
Yeah.
I hope I'm good at it, honestly.
Yeah.
Because it's very much like...
There's going to be stealth. You know there's going to be...
You have to go get water or you die. If you're hungry, you have to go get something to eat or you die.
Oh, that's cool.
So...
Yeah.
Very much... I mean, it's going to be a true survival.
Yeah.
So, I'm very excited.
It's Yeah, it's an indie game, and it's mm-hmm. developed by Compulsion Games, which is this is only their second game that they've ever made.
Yes, the first game was it kind of looks like the style was similar. It was like on the PS3.
Yeah, it was.
Started with a C as well.
Yeah, it was. I got it here somewhere.
It's shit. It's
Contrast.
Yes.
It was a puzzle. It was a puzzle game. It was just for PC.
Mm-hmm. It also came out for PS3.
Oh, did it? Okay, yeah.
Not till way later, but yeah, it did. Was like their big... Hopefully we see more stuff from it. And also, I think Gearbox is behind it, which...
Yeah, Gearbox published...
because of... is Fortnite.
And
also Gear of War.
Yeah, Gears of War, yeah.
And... I can't think of the other one right at the top of my head, but... Yeah. I'm really excited for it. I love the art of it.
Really yeah, cool. It does look really cool.
Yeah.
So, this game takes place in the mid-1960s in the fictional English city of Wellington Wells, a dystopian, retrofuturistic, fashioned, drug-fueled society formed following an alternative timeline of events within World War II, which is on the verge of collapse.
Very nice.
So, that's a little bit of background. And then reading some of the, the drug known as Joy, and they have to take it, and you play as one of three characters starting out, and you're considered a downer because you're trying to get off the drug,
mm-hmm.
and the reason for getting off the drug is because you have something personal you have to accomplish while you're sober, I guess.
Oh, that's what, I never really knew what your motivation was.
It just says, I'm just reading off the wiki page, so good enough, okay, it's close enough, but it says that, let me find it here.
You, work as like
you must survive long enough to complete something important and personal to you. So we don't know what that is yet, but...
So the little bit of the trailer that first debuted, it shows you, I guess you work at like a newspaper place, it looks like. Like a place.
That's the only trailer I've seen is the one.
Telegraph.
Thing. Yeah.
And he looks at a time, and it looks like it shows like his brother. I don't know, maybe his brother's passed, or maybe he was a downer trying to get off the drug and they killed him. I don't know. Like, but it looks like that may be a plot.
Yeah.
But it
could be.
We'll see. I'm very excited about it, though. I love the art to it. I like the concept. I love the creepy-esque of it.
Yeah.
I've known about it for a second, but it's been taken forever to come out on console. So, hopefully... I think it's awesome. That collector's edition looks really awesome.
Yeah, it did look really cool.
Yeah, it's like a box, and it also comes with like a replica of one of the masks that they were wearing, that they're all happy and shit. Love is Blind.
So it is, yeah, that one I'm also excited about. That's the next thing. Just a little bit more about We Happy Few. It was influenced by Clockwork Orange, V for Vendetta, Doctor Who, and Brazil, which is a film. I've never heard of that before this, but
Ooh,
apparently
I've
it's.
heard about it. Apparently it's
Oh yeah, so that's what they were influenced with that, and then their humor stems, the humor within the game stems from Monty Python and a movie called Blow Up.
very British,
Yeah,
though.
very
Very British
British,
humor.
very, very British. And the team Compulsion, Compulsion Games is actually Canadian. So, yeah. But see, there was another cool thing here. Let me find it. Okay. In developing the title, Compulsion Games wanted the player to feel paranoia as they try to determine what actions they need to take, moral gray area, and crafting a simulation that provides an intelligent response and maintains suspense of belief based on how the player performs in the game. And then,
So this would be super survival.
have to like find my notes again.
And you only have melee weapons, as far as I know, that I've saw.
Yeah.
You're not gonna have like a
And like your
fucking gun or
fists and
anything like
stuff.
that. Which is because, I mean, the British culture, they're police officers, don't even have guns, so.
Dang it. There was another really cool. I can't find it now, but there was something else in their wiki page that was really cool that I wanted to talk about, but I can't find it. About how. How prescription drugs are so embedded in our society right now.
Yeah, like that. There's like
Oh, here it is.
that thing there.
Some inspiration for We Happy Few came at the end of Contrast development as studio founder and producer Guillaume, sorry, Provost. It's a weird name, I'm sorry. Had to struggle with the death of his father 3 weeks before Contrast shipped. During this time, he had reflected on his state of life and came up with the ideas for We Happy Few in his emotional distress, particularly the idea of society fixated on drugs and masks. Provost presented this to his creative team, who saw the possibilities of expanding on this.
Dang. Okay, so I
Yeah.
mean that's true. It's basically these days it's like,
Yeah.
oh, you sad? Here's a pill for that.
I
Instead of
mean,
actually going to the source of the problem.
yeah, and there's that documentary on Netflix about how,
Yeah, take your pill.
yeah,
I'm gonna give it to
kids are
you.
just like, Adderall, 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 like it's
Adderall,
Pez candy. Not that they would know what Pez
Adderall. We hope not.
is, but. Yeah,
I don't
so.
know your life, but
Yeah, so I'm pretty excited about that. So we can go to the next one if you want.
cool.
Just
I
click
mean,
on it.
I'm super pumped for We Happy Few. I was
Me
the only
too.
one when I was like yourself that was really excited about that. But I would tell a lot of customers, and they seem really invested, like
Yeah,
interested in that.
it looks
So
super cool.
yeah, I'm really excited. So this next trailer is gonna be for Biomutant.
Yeah, have you heard about it?
No, I don't think so. But the bullets are robots. So things are fucked up.
I love how cinematic these trailers are.
Indeed. There we go.
Graphics look amazing.
Yeah.
It's so colorful.
Yeah, he's so cute.
So it looks like very much, maybe like a poster of apocalyptic thing.
Yeah.
The animals are like human qualities. Or is that human in the universe? Alright. I'm curious on, like, the gameplay. I wonder if it's going to be, what do you call it?
So, it's going to be third person, and it's open world action-adventure game.
Okay. So, I was afraid it was going to be turn-based a little bit.
No. I don't think it's turn... Not... From anything that I read, I don't think it's turn-based.
Okay. I'm curious on the story.
So you start out...
As Rocket, if he was...
Yeah, pretty much. And you get to... you get to determine what your attributes physically are. Cool. And based on, like, if you make your character bigger, then he's going to be slower, but he's going to have more damage.
Like, yeah.
If you make him smaller, he's going to be faster. Stuff like that.
Gotcha.
That's, like, the thing that you start off with. Okay, so I'm just going to read a little bit here. Okay. Wikipedia. Biomutant is an action role-playing game set in an open-world environment played from third-person perspective, in which the player takes control of raccoon-like creature. Yep, I literally just told you all this stuff. You change their fur, fangs, thickness, all that stuff. Okay. Let me plot. Okay. Biomutant has branching storylines where decisions made by the player will decide how the story will continue. The world of Biomutant is struck by a natural disaster as poisonous oil comes up from beneath the surface and pollutes the Tree of Life. The Tree of Life has 5 roots through which it gives life to the whole world. In order to save the Tree of Life, players need to go to the end of each root, where aside from the oil, a creature is destroying the root by gnawing at it. There are also 6 tribes that are split from their original enclave. 3 of them want to heal the Tree of Life, while the 3 others plan to do things on their own. Each tribe can be influenced through the karma system. The player can ally with the tribe and eliminate other tribes in order to grow the power of the allied tribe in the world, although the player can also decide on the Tree of Life's fate without having to murder any of the tribes if they want to.
Okay.
And I believe this game... Let me see if I can find references to it. I believe, like, you can play... It's multiplayer and single player.
Oh.
And... Nope. I'm thinking of another game. I'm thinking of the next one that we're talking about. It's just single player.
This one did look like single player.
It's just single player, yeah.
That's fine with me, personally. I'm not a huge multiplayer
kind of. Yeah, the next one is single player and multiplayer. The next one is super cool.
Cool.
But, yeah, so...
I'd like to see a little bit more... things on this one. I want to know a little bit more about the character.
Yeah.
So there's an infection going on in the end.
Yeah, everything's,
So
some sort of oil is making everything mutant-y.
Okay, so
and you always start out as the raccoon.
Yeah.
But you change his attributes and stuff.
So it's just like a world where there's no humans kind of thing, you just...
Yeah, yeah, everything is animals. And the engine is Unreal Engine 4.
Let me see.
The developer is Experiment 101, and the publisher is THQ Nordic. I've never heard of them.
I've heard of that, but I can't picture
what else they've done. Well, the Unreal Engine, I think, is used in a lot of games. I think
it's
pretty. I don't really know a whole lot about engines, but I think it's a... What is happening, guys? Yeah, and it's going to be available on all systems.
The loudest music. It's music. It's that THQ.
Oh, yeah. TMX. That's what it was. TMX. Wasn't it? TMX?
Maybe, but the one I'm thinking of is that one that's...
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
That's the same one, not the THQ.
Is it?
Is it not? Oh, never mind. Maybe it's not. Yeah, maybe you're right. Yeah, that's...
But Experiment 101, the people that developed it are Swedish. So,
there we go.
I don't know. It's their first game that they've developed. So,
okay.
That's pretty cool.
Good deal.
It's pretty cool. Some indie games going on. Is it considered indie? I don't think it's. Is it considered an indie game?
Is
it a first game?
I mean, unless they've got like.
What qualifies as an indie game?
I think what qualifies as an indie game is like maybe like publishers that are like maybe one or two people and they have their own name and brand and stuff.
I think
if this one's got people like big people behind them, I wouldn't really call it indie. But
they only have 20 employees as of.
I'd say that's indie.
Last month they only had 20 employees.
That's
crazy because you think of like game developers now and they have like entire.
I mean, they have buildings.
Like buildings.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. They have, like, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I consider that indie.
Yeah.
Because I consider We Happy Few an indie-ish.
Like yeah,
indie-ish.
It is. I mean, indie-ish.
Like an indie game. So, yeah. That's
just click that and then skip the ad.
Gotcha. Hurry up, Carol. Oh, wow, this one's got a lot of hype.
Move the mouse off the side. Like off the side of the screen. Yeah.
No, I have heard a lot about this game.
Those graphics, dude.
Are crazy. This is gonna be I think the game that comes out when like the next
Yeah. Boob pocket. He just kissed that and it was in her boob sweat.
I mean.
It looks so good. It's almost kind of racist there because, like, the music and the background is very Asian, and that guy was a pig, and, like, Asians, like, eat a lot of pork, you know.
Do they?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know, maybe I'm just making it up. No, but it feels like it was racist. I don't know.
The guy that's I don't know who the voicer is, but he sounds like the guy that's in Kingsman and also in the movie Sing as the Death Monkey.
Oh, yeah, maybe. If so, he plays with monkeys a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So far.
Two out of two.
The graphics look insane. This is definitely going to be a game that comes out not to like, to when the concert comes out. Because this is like something they're holding out on.
Yeah, I'm pretty, hopefully I can find my notes on that one because there was a lot of good, there was a lot of good stuff.
Like a 2020 game, I'd say. They'll say this year or next year, but I bet you things will be wrong. The graphics are just too, like, crazy.
There is a little bit. They did release some, but I don't think I pulled up that trailer.
I do know that this game's been in the works for like 13 years or something, right? Like something crazy.
Well, yeah, so this, the first one was created in 2003.
And then this one's been in the works since a little after that.
Yeah.
That's the only thing that scares me. It's games that take forever to be made. I'm sure it'll be, hopefully it'll be awesome. But like, The Last Guardian was always another game that was been.
Yeah, 2003. Published and developed by Ubisoft.
Nice.
Yeah.
Cool deal.
The premiere for the years.
That's neat. I mean, it looks cool. It looks fun. It looks wacky.
So when the first one came out, it developed a cult following, mm-hmm. but it was actually considered a commercial failure. They wanted to do a trilogy when they released the first one.
Oh.
That was always their plan, was to do a trilogy. I don't know if it still is, because, you know, it's taken them so long to...
They're still calling it two.
Yeah.
So it's not like it's just called whatever. Good,
yeah.
What is it? Good person. But Beyond,
Beyond
Good and
Evil.
Evil.
Yeah. Poor sales of this game left the publisher, Ubisoft, reluctant to invest in the sequel, so that's why it's taken it. That, plus their concepts were, like, before technology could support their concepts, so
yeah.
That was another thing. Rumors started circulating in 2007, and 2008, Ansel... Which is the... Let me find his name. Let me find his first name here. Oh, no. He's one of the developers.
Okay.
I can't find his name. His last name's Ansel, though. But he said in May 2008 that the sequel had been in production for over a year. But it hadn't been approved yet. So it took him a long time just to get it approved.
Crazy.
And then, these trailers came out in 2016, I think.
Yeah, 2016, it's not been that long.
So they put the works of this game on hold for, development of Rayman Legends, which came out in 2013, and this game actually... enabled them to produce tools that would help them in the production of Beyond Good and Evil 2.
Yeah,
so
it's Ubisoft too, and they've had a lot of other projects they've been trying to fucking fix, like Assassin's
yeah.
Creed. And cause that was their baby there for a second, and then they fucking run that to the ground, and now they
yeah
fix it.
Yeah.
And
so this game is a sequel, game wise as to what was released. But it's actually a prequel in the game timeline.
Gotcha. So is it going to be an action game?
Yeah, it's going to be... it's going to have open world, and it is... Let me find here. Gameplay. Action, adventure, open world. It's going to be played from third person.
Cool.
Yeah, so it has more traditional role-playing elements compared to the first game. The player will generate a character that starts the game at the very bottom of the social system. The character can be male or female, and as the player completes various tasks, they will improve in various attributes and gain spacecraft and crew members, which they can also improve over time. The player will visit planets that have their own societies. By completing tasks on these planets, will gain new technologies or other facets to improve their spacecraft. And the director, there's his name, Michael. What's his first name? Michael or Mitchell? Is that Mitchell? I think it's Mitchell. Mitchell Ansel said that they do anticipate there will be a narrative element that includes fixed story elements.
Cool.
As well as events based on decisions. But yes, yeah, so the single player and co-op, even as single player, the player can participate in a shared universe with some events affecting all players that are playing at the time.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Now that would be really cool. That would be different.
That's pretty cool. And they're going to have like worlds that you go to.
Nice. Nice.
So everything's open world. And then on top of that, they also want you to be able to go to different planets.
Nice.
That's crazy.
That is crazy.
Like, just imagine how... Yeah, that's going to be a big game.
That's definitely going to be a different type of engine system.
Yeah, so they've been.
That's PlayStation 5 worthy.
Yeah.
Whenever that may come out, I honestly don't see it ever coming out until like 2020, 2021.
Which, if you think about it, we're close to getting a new console, like timeline
Yeah,
wise.
it's crazy though.
If you
It's
look
crazy to
at,
think that.
yeah, because Xbox One came out in 2013.
Yeah, they both did. Yeah, 2013. So that would have. So that makes 5 years. The PS3 and 360 had a runtime about 8 to 7 years. So that would be a really
Yeah.
long time.
So I found this paragraph here. A core element of the game is the ability to explore several different planets via space travel. To power this, Ansel and the Montpellier, well, Ubisoft
Yeah.
team started building a solar system simulation tool about 3 years prior to E3 2017 reveal. This tool uses a combination of design elements and procedural generation to assemble those elements for a given planet. Excuse me. Only just before E3 2017, they completed the preliminary work on the tool so that they can then start building the rest of the game around it. Ansel considered that they were only at day zero for the game's development. And this was just last year.
Yeah, I thought, yeah,
So they've pretty much just been doing concepts up until this point. Oh, yeah.
Thanks for sliding out my ass. Okay.
Slotting out my ass. Can we put that on a blooper reel? Because I'll just start the video with
Yes.
that. Sliding out my ass.
Yes. All right, cool. So this one,
Yeah, so I want to do
I
this one before the last. We got two more, this one and one more. So I want to do this one first because I'm hype about this one.
Cool.
Go for it. I think I picked a shorter one too. I tried to at least.
This one's the first trailer.
It might
You're
be.
wrong. No, this is the second trailer. I don't know. I'll let you know just in case.
Oh,
As the first trailer. Yeah.
fun fact, the band that is playing is Low Roar, and they are a Swedish band, I believe.
Cool. This is much dead crabs. I have a little theory on this game, but
Yeah. There are so many theories
yeah,
surrounding this
there
game. I could do an entire podcast on Death Stranding
Yeah.
and Hideo Kojima.
Yeah, like, there's theories that this is not even a game, it's just his little project for a short film.
That would piss me off.
That would be right.
That would piss me
PT
off.
all over
I
again.
would be so angry. Well, there's a lot of theories with that and PT, though.
I heard that they
Being a
might want to do that.
continuation.
Yeah, I heard that they want to try to, like,
I watched a lot of theory videos on that because Silent Hill is bae, as I've said before.
Yes.
And that would be the ultimate thing for me, is if this game was a continuation. I don't think it is, but.
But the thing was, this is super future. Like, you could tell, this is going to be super futuristic.
Yeah.
So, and it didn't seem like PT was.
Yeah. There are equations. If you zoom in on those tablets on his chest,
Yeah.
there are black hole related equations scribbled on those.
Black hole.
Yeah, like wormhole, like time travel, black hole.
Oh, that's creepy.
Yeah.
I didn't know that until now.
You didn't know what?
I didn't know that was people floating in the air until I
Yeah.
saw, I think, another
They're thought to
trailer.
be like some sort of being, maybe. Like a humanoid type being. Because in the next,
Like a
in
dis-
the other trailer, you see
Yeah.
a giant, which is like resembles. Yeah.
Yeah, anyone with Walking Dead, this guy's gonna be in it, so. We'll give that.
You know, I loved him from Boondock Saints. Did you ever see those movies?
No, I've always heard them watching them.
They're so good. I loved them. I loved them. And then, you know, he did those way before Walking Dead was even a thing. Yeah, I don't like it either. But. Oh. I didn't know I did this video. Yeah, you can. I think that's the whole. Yeah, that's the whole video.
So.
Yes.
So that game I'm really excited about. My husband. Confused myself, but I think they're kind of. I don't really know as much anymore with these other trailers, but
yeah,
it's crazy. It's all over the place.
A lot of the theories, and I've watched hours and hours of theory videos on this, is that it's directly related.
That trailer's 9 minutes long.
Yeah. I didn't put that one on there because it was like forever.
Too long.
But it's really good though. There's a lot of really subtle hints to what's going on and. Mm-hmm. You know, all that stuff in it. Which is what Hideo Kojima is known for. He's known for his detailed work and stuff. Yeah, he is weird, and I love it. Yeah. I love it so much.
Yeah.
I follow him on Instagram. He's amazing.
Weird people make creative things.
Yeah. But, so, there's a lot of theories about it being a continuation of Silent Hills.
Okay.
And there are so many things that connect the two that completely make sense.
Do you think it's because of that baby?
The umbilical cord is also in both of them. The fact of an umbilical cord. Because if you, like, you played PT, right?
Oh, yeah. I still have it.
Yeah. So, well, I've never actually played it. I've only seen gameplay. So, we should play it. But anyways, so there's this one part where he hears over the radio, he's talking about the guy who strangled with a rope or whatever, strangled somebody in the garage or whatever over the radio.
Like the radio.
And in the background, there's a second voice repeating the same thing, but when he says rope, the other voice says umbilical cord, but it's really, really faint, and you have to listen in to hear it. And there's stuff like, that tie in with it. The fact that it's called Silent Hills instead of Silent Hill...
Yeah.
Kind of references, maybe implies that there's going to be multiple universes, like multiple parallel universes of Silent Hill.
Yeah.
And so, it also, Norman Reedus, obviously, the big one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was a big deal.
They used the same band, Low Roar, did the same music, from the same album. The same album in both games. PT came out in 2015. Right?
Came out what?
2015 was PT.
Sounds right.
Yeah. I think. So, they used the same album. Even the cover.
I wonder what the name of the songs are. I wonder if they kind of give anything.
Low Roar. I'll Keep Coming. Look at the cover of the song. The cover of their album. It looks like Norman Reedus with the umbilical cord shit coming down. I'll try to include the picture of it, like, in the video, on the bottom of the video.
Yeah.
And so it's like every little detail of PT connects to Death Stranding, and which would be an awesome concept. Like, I'm not going to go over everything, because it's literally hours. Like, you could do a whole podcast about it. But I think what happens, because, you know, Konami still has rights to Silent Hill and all that. So, I think what makes more sense to me is that he had all these ideas brewing for PT and then he left the company. So now he's converting it into Death Stranding. So I don't think it's going to be connected per se, but I think he transferred a lot of his ideas. But he loves leaving stuff up to fans to figure out. That's his favorite thing in the world.
Yeah.
So he actually shared or he either shared or liked some of the theory videos. Yeah, so.
And of course now the Academy Award winning director, he has a lot to do with it too.
Yeah, yeah, that's another connection. He worked with PT as well. Guerrero? I don't know.
The last name.
Del Toro, that guy.
Yeah. Yeah, and he's in that that long, one of the trailers. Not the long ass one, but he's in like, you know.
Yeah, he's a character in the game.
There's now officially 3 trailers for it, which mm-hmm. is cool. Yeah, I think there's gonna be, I guess, aliens or something from another something.
Yeah.
But I was thinking, my little theory. I don't have like a whole like I answer every question, but I think. Do you see men with like the cut in their
yeah.
stomach? I'm wondering if like, it's a world of war, like a world of there's just war and death and. There's almost no people left, so they've found a way to not just... Because there's no... I haven't saw any women in this.
That's true.
So I wonder if women have extinct and they have no way to...
Reproduce.
So I think maybe they found a way to have it where men can carry babies. And that's why there's...
That's an interesting theory, but I don't think it's right.
I mean...
I think the baby that comes in and out of the picture is related to the time travel aspect of it. Because
yeah,
if you notice...
Fading. Yeah, it fades away, and then you see the little steps.
Yeah, and it actually, like, there's a theory that it lines up with the other trailer with Del Toro, because he holds the thing and the baby pops up. So
yeah.
Some people are thinking maybe he left Rita's. The baby left Rita's and went
yeah.
to Del Toro whenever he plugged in his umbilical cord and, like, summoned it, per se.
Yeah.
And then, once the baby came, like, the water started rising and all that stuff.
Right. And then the long-ass trailer that's 9 minutes long shows, like, not a baby, but it shows, like, handprints. That's why that, like, there's a part where that guy freaks out because it's like, oh, it's after me, and they have to, like, get the thing.
The baby's in that trailer, it's just not as prominent. Like, they have the carrier.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's in
yeah.
the shaker thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
it's in a drink mixer.
Yeah, he's in, like, a tiny, like, a fucking, probably, like,
yeah.
third-term baby. Like, not full-grown baby.
Yeah.
Right. Like, yeah. Yeah, now I remember.
Which is kind of cruel, because they're just using a baby, which is, I don't know. We'll learn more story behind it, but...
Yeah. That's interesting.
I'm
excited for it, and actually a really cool thing,
yeah.
an engine that's called, it's a Digma, I think is the
Enigma?
Engine using. Yeah, it's like, D, it starts with a D. But that's the engine that Death Stranding's using, and that is the exact same engine Horizon Zero Dawn used. And there's actually Easter eggs in Horizon Zero Dawn, or Death Stranding.
Yeah.
Which is really cool.
So
those dog tags that he's wearing, that's in Horizon Zero Dawn. There's a dead soldier.
Decima,
that's it. It's on one of the dead soldiers that you find
yeah.
in the game, and he's wearing that.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And then where you see Norman Reedus?
Yeah.
Okay. You know, when he's laying down, he has those cuffs on,
mm-hmm.
like futuristic like handcuffs. You can find those handcuffs in the game, too, in Horizon Zero Dawn, when you're in one of, they're called cauldrons, and it's from the future, or not really. But when there are these old labs that's in the underground, but you can find those handcuffs there, too.
Yeah.
And then, the baby, the one that floats in that second trailer, that's floating, and it's like a cricket eyes and... the cut.
Yeah.
Belly.
Yeah.
You can find that doll in Horizon Zero Dawn, too.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's another thing, is that Norman Reedus' character and the baby, the doll baby,
mm-hmm.
both have cuts, like, the exact
yeah.
same incisions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder if
I don't know.
I wonder if
it's- and in the one with Del Toro, like, whenever the baby hits the bad guy's leg and it opens one eye.
Mm-hmm.
It goes to the baby, the real life baby, and that real life baby only opens one eye, the same eye.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So it's like,
there's a lot of like real subtle, yeah. There's so many real subtle things in the trailers.
Interesting.
But he has confirmed that the death in Death Stranding, like when you die, is something that he's wanted to make different from any other video game. So, what happens when you die is anything that happens is still there. Like, there's no going back. It's only forward.
Yeah.
So there's no, like, there's no, like, I couldn't beat this boss, or the boss blew up, or whatever, you're dead, go back and try again. It's continuously forward, so whatever happens, happens. And when you die, the other trailer, the one where he's underwater,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm talking about? That is you in your death sequence. So that is going to be, I think it's going to be first person, whereas the rest of the game is third person. And you have to swim to your body. And as you're on your way to your body, you can collect the stuff you had on you in the water. And then when you get to your body, you wake up again.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
It seems like it's going to be, like, it's going to really change the game, the way you play. I feel like it's going to be totally different. It's not going to be considered, like, an action adventure or a horror or a... anything. I think it's going to be its own thing.
Category.
Yeah. I'm really interested in what the gameplay is going to be like.
Yeah.
I haven't saw anything of that yet, but...
One of the things I find really interesting about Kojima is that he wants to make the game feel, like, as real as he possibly can, and not just with, like, the engine or the graphics or the technology or whatever, but with the storyline and incorporating it, making everything make sense. So instead of just having a health bar or whatever, he explains your health to you, like it's on a wrist and it pays attention to your injuries and stuff. Or in a game that has abilities, like you can jump super high, that's not normal. Something like that. If Kojima had a game like that, then he would explain why you're able to jump like that. And it, like, kind of blurs that line between reality and the game a little
right.
bit.
Interesting.
It's pretty cool.
I think this game's going to be one that waits for the next system, unfortunately.
Yeah. I'm hoping this year's E3 they might reveal a little bit more at least, but it is scheduled for late 2018.
Yeah. That's what it is.
So,
unfortunately. It does. It's crazy. They gotta work fast.
Yeah.
But I think it's gonna be...
I mean, he's had ideas and been producing this since... Yeah, he's been... And he was creating it when he was doing Metal Gear Solid and PT and all that. He was at least creating the ideas.
Yeah.
Whether it was a completely separate game from PT or whether he took the ideas from PT and transferred them into Death Stranding.
Mm-hmm.
Either way...
I like that there's a theory of, like, some type of connection with PT. That's
I'm gonna find those videos and put a link in the description of this video because they're really awesome.
Yeah.
They're, like, a couple hours long. There's, like, three of them. But this one, I don't remember who published them, but they're really, really good. They're really good videos.
Yeah.
Like, everything makes sense. It makes perfect sense. But in reality, you know, it would be crazy if... Kojima actually worked with Konami with how they ended things.
Yeah.
Unless all that, now that's another theory, that all that was a big sham and they're actually working together to make Silent Hills a thing, but I don't think that's real.
I don't think so either, but
I don't think that's real.
Cool,
I feel like that would piss more people off than it would make people excited, you know, because that's like
if you release that, people are going to be like, well, why the hell did we not get Silent Hills then? Everyone was like, because the reason we didn't get it is because he left that company.
Yeah.
And if you find out he didn't leave the company, you're like, well, we wanted that.
Well, he definitely left, but some people are theorizing that him and Konami still working together to create this. Like, they're giving him the okay to continue Silent Hills, even though...
technically their thing.
Yeah.
Interesting. I know what this one is, too.
Yeah, because you can see for some reason, my computer is, like, not... I have two computers, and neither one of them are working right. Whatever. Yeah.
This is the second trailer to The Last of Us 2.
Yeah. I didn't realize I had clicked on this video. I thought I just picked the trailer, but I guess...
It should just... It'll probably get there for actual video.
There it goes. Okay, cool. Now, this was the second trailer released.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because the first one, I don't even really consider it a trailer. This is basically announces that they're making a second one.
Yeah, it's just like a cinematic clip. Although there are lots of theories based on that trailer, too.
Yeah. Yeah, because she's got the tattoo that covers her bite mark and shit.
Now, people think that this is a prologue. And they think it's set in... At least this part of the game is set in Seattle. Because at a certain point, you can see... Obviously, it's raining. And at a certain point, you can see road signs in the distance. Yeah. And there are some people that think that she is Ellie's mom. Because the chick tries to cut her abdomen or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But if you watch the video, those are males and they have the same abdomen cut.
Right. Yeah.
So that wouldn't make any sense.
Yeah. Maybe it's just her. Maybe it's just the killer's way of killing. Like, that's just their, like, signature.
Yeah. Because, I mean, they're obviously crazy religious people, so yeah. They're doing something insane, cult
like. I wonder if maybe these are, like, gay people. And, like, they're killing all their homosexuals.
It could be. You come up with some crazy theories.
I mean,
I don't know. It could be. She says she's infested with sin.
Yeah.
Nested with sin. And then she tells her to breathe in. And then she starts saying, like, a prayer.
It's probably a religious thing.
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't think it's related to her being pregnant.
Right, no. I don't think so either.
Yeah.
I think it's probably a way to prevent them from getting pregnant.
It could be, but then they also had that male that was strung up that had the same incision.
It's probably the lead out the evil.
Yeah, I don't know. Or maybe they think she's infected, so they want to cut it out. Maybe they think that's the way. Mm-hmm. Oh god, this part makes me cringe so bad.
Yeah, man, it's intense. This game's
and it's like more it's like so realistic. Oh. Oh my god. Like I feel her arm hurts me. Just merciless. I don't think that this is a prequel because to be desensitized to killing people, there's no way that the characters would develop that at the beginning of the apocalypse. You know what I mean?
Like that fast.
They would
like
still,
this is
yeah.
A few years,
yeah, they would
like...
still have. Reserves, like, you know, like, oh, I can't do that or whatever. Whereas 20 years later in The Last of Us Part 1, they're, you know, killing's killing. You gotta do what you gotta do to survive.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think that this is... If it is a prequel, it's, like, right before the first one. It's not at the beginning of the
right.
apocalypse.
I mean, it could be, because... Maybe, because just because I saw that Asian lady, she has, like, pretty nice clothes on. So
yeah, but she also has the same style hair as the chick that just attacked her, so she mm-hmm. could have escaped their cult or whatever. Okay. I love how ripped she is.
I want brighter.
It makes me so excited. That's the first female... Sorry, I keep burping. That's the first female character I've seen in a video game that's really muscular and that's represented that way.
Yeah.
Alright, you can pause
it. Not a dog! My man! Or, not a man, but...
Yeah.
My company!
Yeah.
Because I love fucking Uncharted. that's cool.
Yeah. There it is. Hit the escape button on that one.
Oh, is this it?
I had, like, Last of Us, the original game trailer, just so we could compare the graphics, because it's, like, super... I think escape on the keyboard, because the thing is behind the... There we go. Yeah, and then I have... Oh, I had the other trailer up, too.
Okay.
That one. Which we could just watch that one, and then watch the original Last of Us, because the graphics, even though it doesn't really disclose a whole lot, this one...
This one, right?
Yeah, click on it and then blow it up.
Yep.
And then it's not recording anymore, so pause it. There we go. Now hit the Windows button and the letter G on the keyboard. Yeah, it looks just like the Windows. It's on the bottom part.
There we are.
And letter G. You have to hit them at the same time.
Oh.
So click off of that. Okay. It's okay. Oh, my butt was falling asleep anyways.
Oh, my ass is asleep.
Okay. There we go. Okay. You ready? So last little bit. We're almost done. You going to the gym?
No, he thought we were. Not the gym open yet.
Oh, no. Check back in May.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
Now here's the first trailer for Last of Us 2 of our original players that we played.
The graphics. Oh my gosh.
PlayStation don't fuck around, man.
Yeah.
A lot of these... A lot of games that are exclusive to PlayStation are just immaculate. So there's the...
Firefly.
Firefly.
Close enough. Off-brand Firefly. Dragonfly. So amazing. Oh, that's so good. Of Jared right now.
Oh,
I don't know what's happening. This is the first time they have the ability to capture eyes that close.
Mm-hmm.
So good. She's so badass now.
Yeah. She's
There's a theory about this that, what was his name?
Joel?
Joel?
Yeah.
That Joel's actually dead and she's, imagining him.
Yeah.
'Cause he wasn't in the house with her when she killed all these people and his clothes are clean. Like, you don't have any blood on him or anything.
No.
And if you see certain parts, he doesn't have any gray in his hair and stuff. Yeah.
Oh, man.
And she's just, like, talking to him. That's a badass theory, though.
Yeah. I like Joel, though.
Yeah, I do, too. He's a softie.
hair right now. And they don't show his face either.
Yeah. That would also be a good premise as to why she would want to kill a bunch of people. If they killed him. Yeah. That'd be crazy.
Yeah. And if, you know, if you're in that world, and you're all by yourself, who knows what your mom could do?
Yeah. Yeah. Right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's so little Joel. I mean, I love Ellie too. Actually,
she is one hell of a badass, though. One thing's for sure that we know from that trailer is that Joel did not help her with that.
No.
With killing those people.
No.
He came in after it was done, and he didn't have any blood on him. So, whether he's real or not, he didn't help. And so, she did all that by herself. She fucked some people up. And they're not just dead. They're like, all of their blood is on the floor. They're massacred.
Yeah, for sure.
So, she is fucked in the head. Whatever happened to her tore her up, and she is now, like, out for blood.
Yeah, I mean, for sure.
Yeah.
Unless, if that second trailer has anything to do with this first trailer, I mean, unless...
The only way that...
Is she saying who she's wanting to kill? Is it the...
Just says them.
The dragonfly people? Or?
She just says them. We don't know who she's talking about.
So, is she talking about that weird cult?
She might be, yeah. We might be, you know, maybe that weird cult is a derivation.
Yeah, maybe
I don't know big words. Maybe it's like a side from Fireflies.
If this theory is anywhere correct, like, I wonder if it took Joel.
Yeah. Could be.
And then those people were, of course, like, worked for her.
Yeah.
She was, like, working with dudes, that lady. And they were... The one I saw, anyway, was a guy.
And he was all about protecting her, so he could have died protecting her.
For sure.
Or, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. If the other one is a prequel to Last of Us Part 1, then I think it could work if they do, like, flashback-type things.
Mm-hmm.
But what purpose would that serve? Because giving this trailer, it doesn't really give, like... That doesn't connect to what the story portrays there.
Yeah.
So...
I need to play the first one again, apparently.
Yeah.
I know what happened, but I need to go into it with picking out details.
Yeah. I watched Markiplier. I watched all his... Markiplier. Oh my god. Markiplier. Jesus Christ. I watch him, like, every day. How could I mess that name up? But, yeah. I watched his playthrough of it. And he's never really, he's not a completionist when he does his playthroughs, which is fine, because he has, like, a timeline or whatever.
Right, he just don't
But,
that.
You know, there's a lot of times that he's played stuff, and I'm like, but it's right there, and he's like, oh, shit. He's like, looks the other way. Oh, I'm gonna go this way. No, turn around, it's right there.
I was that way whenever I watched him play Resident Evil 7.
Yeah.
I'm sure he has to kind of get those games done as soon as possible to post it, I'm sure.
And then just for funsies, watch the next video.
Okay, should I just keep pushing?
Did it stop recording?
Because
it's on 7 minutes. It was on an hour. This
no,
one's on an hour.
It.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So this one, just for funsies, we're going to look at The Last was Part 1, the trailer for it, when it came out. Because, yeah, that's going to be awesome. But when, when Last of Us Part 1 came out, it was, like, you know, leading in the industry for graphics and gameplay and stuff, and it was, like, rated number one by everyone, and
It was.
Awesome.
I mean, people were getting the PS3 just to play that game.
Yeah. So this is the trailer from when it came out. So this was the best cinematic of that game in the trailer. Look at the difference. It's just crazy.
You got the PS3, man. That's great.
It's crazy. Oh, that's another thing with Last of Us Part 2. The developer said that hate is a definite theme in that game. Where this one was love, then Part 2 is hate. So, yeah. I love the soundtrack too, it's so good. I hate so bad that they killed her. Yeah, whatever. We spoiled everything. We've been talking forever. I did not plan to make this long of a video, but it is like a couple hours long now.
Season was winter. If you never played it, it actually doesn't go like by chapters or anything. It goes by the seasons. And that's how the game goes.
What does?
The game goes, the first one, of course,
Oh,
goes
yeah.
by seasons.
Yeah, it
And
did.
winter was my favorite season. Like, the games to play. That's when you play the villain.
Yeah.
Jeez,
Yeah.
that was awesome.
Did you ever play the DLC?
No, but
I
I
watched
heard of it.
Markiplier play the
I
DLC.
want
I live through Markiplier because I cannot afford any games right
That's the
now.
cool thing
So,
about social media, of like watching people play stuff, is
yeah.
kind of can live it through them.
Yeah. So you can stop that one. Hit the stop key at, on the blue bar.
Oh.
Yeah. Just stop that. There we go. Nope. Oh, there it goes. Okay. All right, so yeah, we should probably like wrap this up because if not, we're gonna keep talking for all
Yes.
day long. Yeah, so we talked about some of our favorite things and
An introduction to us.
what?
Like an introduction to us.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, this is
Oh my
Cassandra.
gosh. Yes.
Couple hours late, but yeah, I
Yeah.
don't think I ever like. Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, I didn't.
It's all right.
That's okay. Yeah. So,
Yep. So,
yeah.
there you go.
It's games and stuff. I'm gonna try to put out more of these at least once a week,
Nerd
if
porn.
not more, and then just start with a different topic every time and kind
Yeah.
of run with it.
There we
So,
go.
yeah.
There we go.
Anybody who's watching this, if you liked this video, give us a thumbs up for it
And subscribe.
and subscribe. And if you have any ideas of what we should talk about next, just comment and I will read them because I don't get any comments, so I will read yours.
Leave in the comment what is your favorite system?
Yeah.
What one of these games out of these games are you most excited for sure?
Yeah, and hopefully when I edit this later, I will be able to smoosh the two videos together and it won't be hard for me and it won't take 3 days to finish because I have so much video to go through now. But you know, I'm still new at the editing thing, so everything takes forever. But
And I'm sure. I
yeah,
know that
it
that's
sucks. It's fun though. It's great. It's awesome.
awesome.
It's great.
Yeah.
Okay. All
She
right.
goes insane a little bit.
It's great.
It's
Just
great.
fucking great.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, so
Yes.
there we go. All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys. See